Wyoming is going to start off with the football. Nebraska will kick things off. Marl Bondi, the kickoff man for Nebraska. We'll see both Marl Bondi and Pat Smith. It's been a kicker battle that's gone all the way through camp. Neither has really separated themselves, as Bondi will be the guy to kick things off. Back deep for Wyoming, Jalen Claiborne standing in the end zone. And this kickoff through the end zone and out to the 25-yard line for the touchback. And the Wyoming Cowboys will take over with the first possession of the night after the touchback by Bondi. Dave Christensen and this offense had some ups and downs last year. They were the second best passing offense in the Mountain West, but when Brett Smith was injured, they were not near as effective. But Eric, this is a good one, and Brett Smith, the junior for Wyoming.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the offseason, he's trained very, very hard. He's a leader of this team. He's put on some weight because he knows he's going to take some hits this year. Very, very aggressive arm. He's not afraid to throw it downfield, too.
On first down, the motion man, Brandon Miller. And the give is to Sean Wick, and Wick breaking a tackle and pushing the pile all the way out to the 32-yard line. David Santos on the stop for Nebraska. You see your starting lineup for the Wyoming Cowboys rolling across the top of the screen. But a good start for Sean Wick, 204-pound sophomore, as he picks up seven.
You know, defensively, the story for Nebraska is, are they going to be able to stop the interior? They've got some young guys up front. Now, can they get powerful and not let these seven-yard cracks happen?
On second and three, Smith to the air. First pass, first completion. Dominic Rufran out of bounds. And a first down to the 37-yard line. Let's take a look at tonight's Auto Owners Insurance starting defense. And the Huskers with black shirts scrolling across the top of your screen. Seven of those 11 starters with black shirts, the earliest they've been given out since Bo Pelini's been head coach. Pressure on Smith. The side armor slings it out to the 44-yard line. A pickup of seven. Rufran again on the receiving end. Santos and Stanley Jean Baptiste combine on the stop. And the pace of this Wyoming offense is something Dave Christensen wants to push, Eric.
Well, he wants to go extremely fast. They want to be the fastest in the country. And this is one thing you got to watch out for, because Brett Smith will sidestep a player and he'll throw the football with accuracy.
And an injured Husker, and that's injured middle linebacker David Santos, a huge part of Nebraska's revamped and young linebacking core. Santos winning that middle linebacker spot, and that's going to put a true freshman on the spot. Josh Banderas will come in. We were talking with John Papuchis yesterday, and he said Banderas was put to the test early at Mike. We'll see what happened here as Santos comes up a little bit injured. Santos will leave, and Josh Banderas will check in, and he'll play that Mike linebacker spot as a true freshman. Second down and three at the 44. The give to Miller, and Miller down close to a first down, just about a yard shy. And Damon Benning, you are in the midst of this heat on the field. How big of a factor is it?
Yeah, well, it looks like they're just taking a look at, maybe he got hit in what we would call the lower region or the groin. But the key here, guy, is his communication. You know, that was a big deal talking to Coach Pelini yesterday in our meetings. And right away, you can see, especially on the quick out, where Santos could not get the call to Mosise, who surprisingly makes the start at the nickel wheel spot. But guys, if these guys can talk to one another, they can have some success. But I got to tell you, it's deafening down here.
First down. I can imagine. 92,000 or so in this building. Loud on the field, the offsides against Nebraska, and another first down for Wyoming. Dave Christensen wants to play faster than anyone in college football. He told us that the other day. So far, the pace has been to his liking. Pass incomplete. Good coverage, Eric, downfield by Nebraska.
Yeah, sure was. And Brett Smith, you saw him. He was going to give that one up on the first time, but he didn't. Hesitated and then threw the ball out of bounds. Made a smart decision there instead of forcing this one after you've crossed the 50-yard line. You see him with that pump and that hesitate, and then he just threw it out of bounds.
Third-year starter, junior out of Salem, Oregon. On second and 10. Give up the middle to Sean Wick. Thad Randall, one of the most experienced guys on that defensive side for the Huskers, makes the stop, and it'll bring up a big third down for Wyoming.
And as Nebraska, you can see them right now. Sometimes the heat will affect you in your first game with all the nerves and all the anxiety. This team has not settled down yet.
At the 47 of Nebraska, third down and 8. Smith with time. And the pass knocked away, jarred loose by Corey Cooper. He had a clean shot and a clean play as he knocked it away from Dominic Rufram, and Wyoming will punt.
And this is one of the most exciting players in the defensive lineup. This is first start at safety. Corey Cooper just laying the wood right there, saying this isn't going to happen on the first drive.
So now Corey Cooper able to knock it loose, the junior out of Maywood, Illinois. And Jamal Turner back to return this punt. Huskers in the Big Ten play last year really struggled in punt return, hanging on to the football. This one not going to get a chance to be returned. Good punt. It'll roll inside the 5, and Taylor Martinez and the Huskers are going to start deep in their own end with their first possession at the 2-yard line. A 45-yard punt. One of the big question marks for Wyoming: how would Ethan Wood, the freshman punter, do? Not a bad start as he pins the Huskers deep. And now this very explosive offense led by that man, Taylor Martinez, who now becomes the first quarterback in Husker history to start 4 straight opens, and he gets a rousing round of applause from the fans as he comes onto the field.
Yes, he does. And every time a quarterback comes in on the 2-yard line, you got to be thinking this might be a run just to open up some space.
Zimmerer, the fullback, Abdullah, the running back, and Amir Abdullah with a pounding run to the 9-yard line.
And this is what Amir Abdullah brings to the table. You saw how fast he stepped up towards the field. A very aggressive type runner. Not a lot of side-to-side movement on that play, just getting some yards.
Speaking of pace, Nebraska cranking it up as Abdullah gets the carry on 2nd down and 3. It ends up about a yard shy at the 11-yard line. Trying that right side, and now 3rd and 1 as the Husker starters scroll atop your screen.
And you got to wonder right now if this is something that they're trying to see if they can move the front of the Wyoming defense. Come out with a few runs here in the first quarter and get a feel with the looks that they're going to be giving.
3rd down and 1 yard. And some movement. Somebody flinched, and it's going to cost the Huskers yardage.
Part of the snap, false start, offense, number 41, 5-yard penalty, remains 3rd down.
Eddie Shelton, our referee, he's a Mountain West official. Keeping an eye on this one as they'll move it back to the 6, and now 3rd and 6 for Nebraska. As we take a look at the top of the screen at tonight's Auto Owners Insurance starting defense for the Wyoming Cowboys. Martinez gonna scramble. Martinez in some trouble. And Taylor Martinez banged out of bounds at the 8-yard line. Lucas Walker to the sideline with good speed, and he knocked him out of bounds, and Nebraska will have to punt.
Well, they brought some pressure from the outside, and this is what had Taylor Martinez's eyes to the right, so he said, I've got to get out of here to the left. And not a bad idea just to pull it down and not force the throw. Tim Beck said in our meetings, Taylor Martinez has got to be smart with the football to keep us in these games and not take the pressure on his own shoulders.
Talking with Joe Gans, former Husker quarterback there, and a great help to Taylor Martinez throughout his career on the sideline. Sam Foulkes punting it away, and a good punt by Foulkes. Fair catch called for by Claiborne and made all the way back near the 36-yard line. Tremendous punt by the redshirt freshman Sam Foulkes, Wyoming's 2nd possession of a scoreless game when we return in a moment on BTN.
Football on BTN is presented by Buick. It's your kind of luxury. And brought to you by Case IH. Be ready with the proven leader. Visit caseih.com/efficientpower.
Quarter with Eric Crouch and Damon Benning. I'm Kevin Kugler. A pleasure to have you with us tonight. It is a steamy night. Those fans trying to put a dent in that heat on the sidelines. I don't know, Eric. Is it helping at all?
Well, I thought you were going to have a mister up here in the booth pointed on you. I wasn't quite sure that. I was surprised to not have it up here.
This is the new grandstand. The mister comes later, you know, once they get done feeding us the grapes. That's how things roll on TV. Let's see the fans in the stands baking in the sun on the high part of that new east grandstand. First down and 10 at the 36-yard line. Brett Smith with four receivers into the pattern on first down. Now Miller will motion out of the backfield. Swing pass to Miller. Santos back on the field. Miller slips the tackle and has the first down. David Santos able to trip him up, but all the way out to the 48, a pickup of 12.
Great job right there by David Santos. Actually, not a great job by David Santos. He really got outflanked, and that's where he lost his position on the football.
From the 48 on first down. Smith will run. Smith's got some wheels. Smith stumbling down as a flag comes in at the 33-yard line. He picks up 19, but wait, the flag is back at the 42.
Hey, guys, if that play looks familiar, you're thinking Missouri 07 and 08 where Brad Smith ran wild, the offensive coordinator those years. Coach Christensen, he's well aware that Nebraska likes to play a ton of man and man under. They get Santos out of the middle and it parts like the Red Sea.
And Smith, Damon, put on some weight to add a little extra muscle mass to be able to handle the contact that comes with plays like that throughout the course of the season. He's up to 206.
Absolutely. And you look at him down here on the field, he's got a great big trunk where he looks to be extremely durable. And I think he's built for the rigor of this season, guys. Fortunate to get a penalty on this one.
The block in the back, bringing it back.
Well, you always wish you had those ones back, but you can tell that Coach Dave Christensen is not afraid to run Brett Smith in this offense.
You know, and we actually asked him that the other day, and he said that's why the weight's been put on.
Right.
We're not going to hold him back. After the penalty, first and 8 for Wyoming. Smith with lots of time. Nobody open. Pressure coming late from Gregory, and he finds his receiver, Robert Huron.
This is why Brett Smith is the player that he is. They love him. Wyoming, because he can do this. He sets his feet. He extends the play. Coaches love this about him. He extends the play, completes the pass to Huron, and they pick up the first down.
Robert Huron with 173 yards last year in the opener for Wyoming against Texas. And Huron gets a first down on the end of that one. Up the middle, a hole for Wick. Wick to the outside. Down the sideline, diving for the pylon, and he's out of bounds. It'll be first and goal, Wyoming, just inside the 4.
Huge play right there by Wick. And this is not a running offense. I mean, this is a straight-up passing offense, and I think that they're showing right now that you have to respect the run. And Rick does have some speed on the outside.
And then some problems in the backfield as Mo Cisse able to trip up Smith all the way back near the 7-yard line. You mentioned this is not a running offense. Last year, Wyoming was 99th in college football at 125 rush yards per game, and they lost who they thought would be their top back this year, DJ May, with a fall injury.
They're showing now that they better respect the run.
Second and goal from the 6. Pressure coming from the backside. Smith elude, touchdown, Claiborne. And Wyoming takes the lead as Brett Smith finds Jalen Claiborne for 6.
Reminiscent of that play back here at about the 40-yard line where Brett Smith ran to his left. And what he's so good at, you see him when he gets flushed out of the pocket, he squares his shoulders up to make that accurate throw to Claiborne.
This large crowd all of a sudden very quiet in Lincoln, Nebraska, as Stuart Williams on for the extra point, and the kick is good. 8:48 remaining in the first quarter. Wyoming strikes first in Lincoln. Early success for the folks from Laramie with a 7-0 lead over Nebraska here in the first quarter. 8:48 remaining in the first, and this scoring drive brought to you by Buick, and the Wyoming Cowboys were able to make some pretty quick work. Six plays, 64 yards, just a minute 57 off the clock, Eric. The tempo was just what Coach Christensen wanted, and the results as well.
Well, you can see they were just trying to get up to the line as fast as they could and try to catch Nebraska really out of position. And one thing on this touchdown, we'll look at it again, is that on defense, you have to get your hands on the receiver. Slow him down. Have him reroute his route. You don't want to give him free rein to run across the field without stopping him a little bit.
Guys, I tell you, and we heard Croaks Christensen's stat where he says if they make a first down, that their success of scoring goes up 26% within a drive. They obviously got a first down and then a touchdown. That's percentage increase.
Well, and the Cowboys making quick work so far of this Nebraska defense. 97 yards already for Wyoming in this first quarter. Kickoff with Kenny Bell on the return. Bell with great speed. Bell out near the 40-yard line. And the Huskers with much better field position to start. Remember, their first possession pinned back at the 2. This time they'll start at the 39 after the explosive return from Kenny Bell.
Well, a nice punt by Ethan. Nice punt early on. Deep, and then the special teams taking effect here. I think right now this is a great way to get some momentum going with your team, the excitement, the energy. We still really haven't seen Nebraska put together a drive yet in this first quarter.
First down and 10 for Nebraska. Martinez to Turner. Jamal Turner got a block from Quincy Enunwa and took it out to the 45-yard line before Jordan Stanton could make the stop.
We're getting the ball to Jamal Turner and Kenny Bell and Quincy Enunwa. This is going to be what this offense is about. You have, remember, you have a running back in the backfield that can catch the ball in Amir Abdullah.
Abdullah will keep, and Abdullah in some trouble. Buried in the backfield at the 43-yard line. And Damon is somebody who played the position of running back. I've got to imagine when you look up as a back and see three white jerseys in front of you, that's not a good thing.
This whole play is to stretch and play with good angles. I know Amir wants to get with, but the quicker he can get those shoulders turned, the better off he's going to be.
Third down and 5 for Nebraska. And a bobbled snap. Martinez trying to keep this play alive. Throwing across his body, tipped and caught. Jake Long with the grab at the 30-yard line.
Wow, what concentration on Taylor Martinez to pick up a bobbled snap and get outside and find a receiver. But the concentration there on Jake Long on catching a tip ball, that's one of the hardest things to do in football.
First down and a gain of a yard to the 30-yard line. Stanton and Walker combine on the stop. Lucas Walker, a freshman playing inside in this new 3-4 for Wyoming, and a guy that's been trying to bulk up. In fact, it's a requirement. Lucas Walker must eat in every team meeting. They want him to put on weight. So far, he's gone from 190 to 214.
I wonder what would happen if we ate in every production meeting.
That would be a bad idea. Martinez trying to find Kenny Bell down the field. Well covered, and the ball thrown away. Third down and 9 for Nebraska at the 30-yard line of Wyoming.
And you don't really sense that Nebraska's really putting together their offense right now. They want to move a little bit faster. I'm seeing the plays coming in a little bit slower, and they're not running the offense the speed, the pace that they want to run at. And as you can see, that affects the efficiency of the play.
Third down and 9. Martinez over the middle. Great catch by Jamal Turner. And a first down for Nebraska inside the 15 at the Wyoming 13. Mark Queston Huff on the tackle, but a 17-yard pickup and a Nebraska first down.
Well, that's exactly what Nebraska needed. You get Jamal Turner across the middle in zone coverage. A great job by Martinez putting his eyes to the right side of the field and throwing that ball inside the linebacker so it's a catchable pass.
Taylor checking out. He's got the ability to change things up, but a flag is thrown. And Nebraska puzzled at the moment as they watch our officiating crew discuss the flag.
There is no foul for a false start. Third down.
Nebraska was just getting ready to get into an unbalanced set, and I think that confused the officials a little bit with the formation. But Eric, you can speak to this. One of the things that Wyoming's doing that's allowed them to have success is the late stem by the D-line causing a little bit of confusion.
Yeah, it does. And the thing that you balance that with is you get up to the line and you call a quick count and get the playoff faster.
Martinez down to the 7. Burns and Huff combine on the stop of Taylor Martinez, but a good gain of 7.
You know, Martinez is a little bit sneaky here. You know, you look at him as a passing quarterback, then he comes back and gouges for some yards on the run.
Abdullah fighting forward, gets that extra yard after contact down to the 4. Jordan Stanton on the stop, and now 3rd and 1 for the Huskers at the 4-yard line. Toss play, Abdullah, and he's drilled to the turf. What a hit, Sonny Pulatasi hammers Amir Abdullah, and the field goal unit will come on.
Well, Pulatasi right here just using his hands and pushing off, getting in there, making a huge hit. Amir Abdullah didn't even know he was in his face until he hit him.
Yeah, he knew it then.
He knew it then.
Kenny Bell trying to block the junior out of Lawton, Oklahoma. Pulatasi tossed him aside, and Abdullah paid the price. Here's Pat Smith walking on after spending a good portion of his career at Western Illinois. And the field goal try by Smith is good. Sneaks in underneath that right upright, and the Huskers have their first points of the ball game. 5 minutes to go in this first quarter, and a sellout crowd hoping their Huskers can rally down by 4. BTN goes where you want, when you want it, with BTN To Go, presented by Auto Owners Insurance. Watch every football game on your computer, tablet, or smartphone. BTN To Go is now available to all major subscribers who receive BTN through their cable, satellite, or participating video providers. To learn more, visit btntogo.com, also available in the App Store and on Google Play. The balloons filling the skies in Lincoln after the Huskers get on the scoreboard with that field goal from Pat Smith. Nebraska with a 10-play, 55-yard drive, capped by that field goal, trailing now 7-3. And the kickoff into the end zone for the touchback. Opelini's defense going back to work, and the last time they were on the field, Eric, Wyoming went right down the field, scored a touchdown. Brett Smith, 3-for-3 on that touchdown drive, and he's now gone 181 passes consecutive without an interception. That's a new Wyoming record and a new Mountain West Conference record.
Well, you got to take your hat off to Brett Smith. He's been able to accomplish that as such a feat. You look at Nebraska's defense, maybe an opportunity here for them to really step up to the plate and make something happen. Bo Pelini's looking attentively at these young players right now.
True freshman Nathan Gary on the field for the Huskers right now. And first down, the toss to Miller. And Miller shoved out of bounds by Ciante Evans near a first down at the 35-yard line. It is a first down for Wyoming.
Damon said earlier, made a good point. When they get a first down, their engine starts to click and their offense really starts to motor. So you want to look out for the pace of this Wyoming offense as they continue this drive downfield.
Here's Wick banging forward to the 41-yard line. David Santos in there on the stop. Also in at the end of that play, Aaron Curry, and a pickup of 6.
We see Wyoming finishing off that run really well. You'd like to think that Nebraska, these linebackers and Santos being a little bit more physical at that point of contact and driving them back.
Second down over the middle. Nice grab and a first down to midfield. Dominic Ruffran already very active, his 3rd catch. Evans and Cooper with the tackle, but Wyoming once again at midfield.
And Ruffran's that back, that possession back. You can see a possession back that can catch the ball with confidence over the middle and make something happen at the end of the run.
That's a favorite target of Smith on first down. Big hole up the middle for Wick, and another first down to the 37-yard line. 13 yards more on the ground. Cowboys are over 70 yards rushing, Damon.
Guys, I'll tell you, it's cat and mouse here. Nebraska plays bracket quarters coverage. The beauty of it is it's hard to get guys open vertically. The tough part is you got 7 guys with their back to the ball once it's in motion. Nebraska has a decision to make. Cover the wide rusher, of jump the crosser, guys. It's UCLA all over again.
Stanley Jean Baptiste with the interception. And Stanley Jean Baptiste across the 40-yard line. Brett Smith's streak is broken. 183 passes before Stanley Jean Baptiste picks him off, and the Huskers get the turnover.
Exactly what Damon said. 25, Nathan Geary had his back to the ball. This is where that bracket coverage takes place. And you can see the throw deep down the middle of the field is an automatic no-no for a quarterback. If you are late throwing down the middle of the field, odds are that that zone is covered.
And it was by the big corner for the Huskers, Stanley Jean Baptiste. And it's first and 10 for Taylor Martinez in the offense at the Husker 42-yard line. Martinez on the keep. First down and more. Inside the 45 to the 44 by Preston Huff on the tackle. So dangerous in the open field. Taylor Martinez gets the first and a pickup of 14.
Well, it's cool to see the option there back in Nebraska. And Taylor Martinez runs it really well. Nice finish at the end of the run by putting his shoulder down and punishing the tackler.
At the Wyoming 44, first down. Option again. Martinez keeps, and this time goes nowhere. Darren White, the junior safety, was there first. Didn't bite on the little head and shoulder fake, and it's second down.
Yeah, no, he didn't. And when you're running speed option, you've got to get to that pitch man with speed. A little bit of jogging out of Martinez that way, and that strung this play out. And this is exactly what happens when you string out the option. Your guys stack up on your quarterback.
Got to accelerate a little bit more into that.
You need to speed outside shoulder of the pitch man and make that pitch.
Second down and 11. Martinez with time. Kenny Bell with the catch. And Nunwell with a block. Great stiff arm from Bell, and he's out of bounds near a first down. Blair Burns on the stop. Huskers a yard shy of moving the chains. But a flag down on the sideline. 10-yard pickup. It's going to be a face mask. Burns was the guy who made the stop. See what the call is.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense number 2. 15-yard penalty at the end of the run. Automatic first down.
Burns ran him out. Huff got over there, and it's Huff who's called for the penalty.
Well, Nebraska has such a great situation. They can spread the ball around the field. Jamal Turner, get the ball to Kenny Bell, who's a very exciting physical runner. And you can see that he used a stiff arm right there to pick up an extra few yards at the end of the run.
Marqueston Huff got announced as the penalty, but you saw it was Burns who had a hold of the face mask there as he made the tackle. First down and 10 from the 20. Martinez over the middle, almost intercepted at the goal line by Darren White. Taylor Martinez got away with one there, Eric.
Yeah, he sure did. It looks like he zeroed in on his receiver. Didn't come all the way back. Field. He stayed on the right side a little bit too long. If he would have came off of him, he would have saw that Kenny Bell had the middle of the field right there wide open.
From the 20-yard line, second down and 10. Bell to the bottom of your screen. Turner and Inunua up top and Abdullah in motion. Swing pass to Amir Abdullah. Inunua trying to hold that block, but he could not keep him clear, and it was Tyran Finley, the junior college transfer, who made the tackle.
And this is the beauty of Tim Beck's offense. You know, you go to one side, you go to the other, you throw a running play in there, and really trying to get Amir Abdullah outside in space because of how quick he is and physical he is to make somebody miss, and he has a touchdown.
True freshman Seathan Carter lined up at tight end on the bottom of that offensive line, as you view it on your screen, number 11. And several youngsters already tonight for Nebraska. Third down and 7. Martinez airing it for Turner, who's open. And Jamal Turner has got the touchdown.
Jamal Turner running a pristine route, setting up this run. Taylor Martinez drops back and throws him a nice pass, arcing, but really The coverage wasn't there. Jamal Turner had him beat with straight speed to the corner of the end zone, and that's what the quarterback's going to do. Taylor Martinez is going to throw it to that corner of the end zone. He's throwing to a spot for Jamal Turner.
Good job to keep his feet in bounds. Got both of them in as Pat Smith tacks on the extra point, and Nebraska, for the first time tonight, takes the lead 10-7. The Huskers with the advantage. Taylor Martinez, first touchdown pass of the year, finds Jamal Turner for six. This October, BTN's award-winning original series is back. It's the show with an unprecedented look inside the Big Ten season. The Journey, Big Ten Football 2013, presented by Best Buy, premieres October 9th on BTN. About a month later then, basketball season will begin in Lincoln, Nebraska, in that new building. In downtown Lincoln, the Pinnacle Bank Arena is open for business this weekend. Everybody coming into Lincoln for the game got a chance to tour the facility. It's where the Husker men and women will play their games beginning this fall and winter. A lot of excitement around Lincoln with that new facility. Marl Bondi to kick off. His first kickoff through the end zone. This one through the end zone as well. And Wyoming will come out to the 25-yard line. First down and 10. Six play, 58-yard drive for the Huskers, Eric, and Nebraska able to find some success through the air on that drive, and with Jamal Turner capping it with the touchdown. Now the defense to work. What do they need to do to slow down a Wyoming offense that so far has been very effective?
Yeah, they have. They've been extremely effective. I think they're going to come out and try to do the same things. They're going to mix the run in. They're going to get the inside linebackers in that bracket coverage back towards the quarterback and then throw a run in there, a draw. But that interception, that last drive, may have given this defense some life now. Takes the pressure off because Nebraska's up 10-7.
From the 25-yard line on first down. Smith on the run. Boy, he hung out Tanner Gentry, the freshman, with that high pass. Stanley Jean Baptiste came up with a big hit, but a clean hit. That's something everybody will be watching all year, that targeting rule. And Damon, your thoughts as you watch from down on the sideline level.
I tell you what, Nebraska's got some decisions to make. I know they like the bracket and combo coverage, but they might have to go to a little man under or a little more true zone, because what's happening is when you have a quarterback that can run the football, it takes your free safety out of the equation. The deep motion by the tailback gets Nebraska to widen, and it softens the middle. Extreme cat and mouse here going on right now, guys.
And third and two on that run up the middle, and now the toss out to Claiborne, and there's Stanley Jean Baptiste again. What a quarter he's had, the senior out of Miami, who Bo Pelini told us found some work ethic to go with his athletic skills, and all that's turned into a very good quarter.
Well, that's why Omi wanted to really speed up the offense right here. Stanley Jean Baptiste was not fooled. He was ready to play. He came up there and hit with physicality, made that tackle, and that's exactly what Nebraska's defense needed to do.
John Papuchis has to be thrilled with what he's seen from Stanley Jean Baptiste. Those guys telling us yesterday about all the work that he put in the offseason to try to get better. Always has been a great physically gifted athlete, but now has everything put together. They're excited for his season. We've reached the end of the first quarter in Lincoln, Nebraska. An entertaining first quarter as the Nebraska Cornhuskers fall behind early, but are able to draw back to the lead on the touchdown pass to Jamal Turner, 10-7 after one. Sean Eichhorst, Nebraska's athletic director on the left. Tom Osborne, the athletic director emeritus, on the right. Mike and Rob Devaney in the middle of that picture, the son and grandson, respectively, of former Husker head coach and athletic director Bob Devaney. And yesterday, Coach Osborne, the Devaney family on hand as the statue was unveiled, the statue of Bob Devaney. Son and grandson able to unveil that statue of that legendary man here at Memorial Stadium, and a fitting tribute. If anybody deserves the statue here, Coach Osborne already has one.
Great history there in the stadium.
And without Bob Devaney, this program's not where it is today.
And Osborne also responsible for a lot of this expansion here at the University of Nebraska.
Flag down. It was fourth and two at the 33-yard line. The flag came in before the punt. You saw Ethan Wood hold on to that one for a long time. See what the flag is here.
Illegal formation. 5 men in the backfield. Offense. 5-yard penalty. remains fourth down.
Let's check in downstairs once again with Damon Bennett.
Talking with our athletic director, Sean Eichhorst, here with Mike Devaney, son of the late, great Bob Devaney. Sean, off air, we were talking about family. He said, this is family. I said, you got a great big smile, and nothing epitomizes that more than the basic building blocks with the son of the great Bob Devaney, and then the new regime and the visionary and Sean Eichhorst. And Mike, talk a little bit about the dedication of the statue and what it means to have this happen.
Well, I tell you, I think it would mean a lot to my father. I think he would have been humbled by it, but I think he would have been very pleased and very honored. The Nebraska people have always been wonderful. He's always loved the state and loved the people. And I think that this is a nice tribute for his efforts here. And also, it says a lot about the people here in the state.
You know, speaking a lot, we talk about bricks and mortar and laying the concrete of a foundation. The foundation of what is Nebraska today had a lot to do with your father and Bob Devaney. Sean, as you take over a very powerful program and one in which has national recognition, what responsibility do you feel as the visionary and the leader of this great tradition?
Well, I think more than anything, Damon, is to pay homage to our history and tradition and understand where we've come from. And certainly Coach Devaney set the tone for that. And Coach Osborne's done a wonderful job, both as a coach and athletics director. So my job is just to keep the thing moving forward. And I'm very pleased to have Mike and Rob and here this weekend. And it's only right that we pay homage to Coach Devaney and all that he's done for us. And it's a perfect framework to have his statue on the east side.
Guys, we appreciate your time. Thanks for sharing.
Thank you very much.
Tremendous leadership, guys. Nebraska's in good hands with their new athletic director in Sean Eichhorst.
Taylor Martinez, with the offense in his hands, gets a first down to the 35-yard line, a pickup of 11, Huff and Lewis on the stop. And as somebody who had the chance to talk to Coach Devaney a few times at the end of his run, his son sounds eerily like his father. Close your eyes and you can hear Bob Devaney and his son Mike. On the 35, Imani Cross with the carry, and Cross pushing the pile, gets an extra yard out to the 38. Uso Olive, redshirt freshman out of the state of Washington, with the tackle.
I've been pretty impressed here with the front of Wyoming's defense. They're physical. They haven't given up a huge play in the running game from Nebraska's offense, something that their coach is happy to see.
Martinez looked tall for Kenny Bell, had Inunua out front blocking, but he could not connect, and now third down and 7. And it's a great game to talk about and unveil a statue of Bob Devaney, because Bob Devaney figures large into the lore of both of these programs. In fact, he's still the winningest head coach in Wyoming history. Look at that record, 35-10-5, and then got on the train and came east from Wyoming to Nebraska. Both of those pictures of his time at each individual stop. Third down and 7. A lot of time for Taylor Martinez, and he finds his tight end, Jake Long, who cannot hang on at the Wyoming 40. Marqueston Huff able to rip the ball out of his hands and force the punt team on for Nebraska.
And Marqueston Huff, a player that requested to make this move to safety. It's his first time back there at this position, and really coming up big, coming in there, swatting the ball and being physical with his hands. Great hand-eye coordination, just getting that ball out of there.
10-7, the advantage, and the punt coming. Sam Foltz punting to Jalen Claiborne. Another good punt by Foltz. Claiborne at the 13-yard line. Claiborne with some running room and slips down just shy of the 25-yard line at the 24. 13:05 remaining in this first half. Nebraska 10, Wyoming 7. The Huskers, now the Huskers, then the old Gold Knights with the lead. Nebraska 10, Wyoming 7. With Eric Crouch and David Benning, I'm Kevin Kugler. Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska. Now for tonight's Marine Corps leader. And our Marine Corps leader tonight, C.J. Zimmerer, the senior fullback from Omaha, Nebraska. Twice academic All-Big Ten. Three-year member of the Brooke Baringer citizenship team. Graduated in December of last year in 3.5 years. And on first down, a gigantic hole for Brett Smith. Smith into Husker territory and out of bounds inside the 35. Harvey Jackson finally able to knock him out. They'll mark him out inside the 30 at the 29-yard line.
That weight gain in the offseason didn't affect his speed at all. Harvey Jackson kind of adjusted and the chin went up in the air like a track meet to try to catch him.
And on first down, the give to Brandon Miller, and not much running room up the middle. Thad Randall, Kevin Maurice right there to make the stop. And the freshman, Kevin Maurice, another true freshman that Bo Pelini really liked when we talked with him about him yesterday.
Yeah, he did. I mean, what he's told us about camp is that these freshmen have really practiced well. And this needs to translate over into the game on game day. All the excitement, being on the field and dressing up for the first time and making that tunnel walk, you got to put that aside and do your assignment-driven jobs right now.
Second and nine. Smith. And the pass incomplete. There's a flag on the sideline. Cisse was tangled up on the sideline with Trey Norman. The pass was intended downfield for Jalen Claiborne.
Holding defense number 4. 10-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
That's a tough one for Bo Pelini's defense because that was not even anywhere.
It wasn't around the ball at
no,
all.
Exactly. So Wyoming gets another first down, and you've got to be very impressed if you're a Wyoming fan at this point with this Dave Christensen called offense, calling plays for the first time as the head coach at Wyoming. What a start he's had on the road.
Well, they're certainly mixing it up. A lot of 3-by-1 formations, 3-by-2, some empty sets.
And now some movement as we talk about some of the good things the offense is doing. This may have been one that cost them some yardage.
False start. Offense, number 51. 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
One of the most veteran men on that offensive line, Tyler Strong. This is his 24th straight start. He's one of the team captains.
Well, when you have something like that, you're team captains. I know that there's a little bit of uncertainty up front. I'm sure that he can shake it off and come back and make something happen in this drive.
First down and 15, Smith, open. At the 15 is Rufran. Rufran, a juke down to the 11-yard line. He picks up 12, Josh Mitchell on the tackle. Stay tuned at the half for the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. Very busy day across college football.
Good job of Brett Smith just taking what the defense has given him.
And second and 3, Miller. Looking for the first down, and he's got it to the 6-yard line. It'll be first and goal. David Santos on the stop, and Damon, Wyoming knocking on the door again.
They are. Nebraska's trying to quell that momentum by keeping the D-line fresh. They're on their 7th D-lineman as you see Kevin Maurice enter the game. They have substituted freely. I know they hope it pays immediate dividends in the second half.
They'd like to see some dividends now on first and goal from the 6-yard line. Wick with the carry, pushing his way to the goal line, and he's in for the touchdown, and Wyoming regains the lead in Lincoln.
Well, another way to get to a 3-by-1 type of a setting. The formation just had a little bit of motion on the outside, which is a little bit tough on the defense because maybe they think something else is coming, a little trickery, but no, just a straight up dive through the middle, and you see the push on Thad Randall. Or actually, that was Avery Mosh that got the push up the defensive line. And what a great run by Miller.
And the extra point by Stu Williams is good. 11:38 remaining in the first half. The Wyoming Cowboys not at all daunted by this giant crowd. They lead by 4. Weeknights, join the conversation on BTN Live. It's the most comprehensive nightly college football discussion from the guys who love to talk about the game. BTN Live, weeknights at 6 Eastern on BTN. There's a guy who's way at the top. Wearing a dark shirt on a night that started at 93 degrees.
Hope he's got his handkerchief in case his nose starts bleeding up there.
Yeah, that's he's not in the front row. Yeah, you can see Wyoming from there. That's in the new East Grandstand. You can see Wyoming from all the way up top. You probably can. Not a lot to impede your view up there. Wyoming with the lead. Kenny Bell a yard deep, and he's going to take a knee and come out to the 25-yard line. A 5-play, 76-yard drive for Wyoming, and it's been the ground game that's got those defensive coaches concerned right now, Eric. Gotcha. Wyoming's right. Running the football.
They are. I think it was set up by that 47-yard run by Brett Smith. And I got to take my hat off right now to Dave Christensen in the play calling, because right now it's a pretty balanced play call. It's not all pass. It's about 50-50. If you remember right, when he was back at Missouri, they were pretty solid at about 50-50, and that's where they wanted to be, to have a balanced offense.
137 rush yards for the Cowboys in the first half. Remember, Wyoming last year 99th in college football, averaging 125 a game. On first down, nudged out of bounds, Kenny Bell close to a first down. Tyran Finley on the stop, and David, those defensive coaches doing a little overtime work during this offensive series.
They are. It's tough to talk about run fits when they can't get the D-line to occupy like they'd like. It seems like it's the miscommunication is happening at the second level. Look for those guys to try to keep getting it right on the dry erase board, because there's a ton of conversation down here about it.
As Kenny Bell gets the first down, Damon, you mentioned earlier that they were rotating a lot in that defensive line. Wyoming's going right up the middle on these guys. Is that rotation hurting Nebraska?
Well, I think so, because sometimes it's hard to get acclimated to the speed of the game. And when you got young bucks like Mo Collins and Kevin Maurice and even Thad Randall, who, guys, hasn't had a ton of work in the offseason, it's almost like a newbie getting ready when you feel guys lean on you. Especially the way that Wyoming likes to handle those guys up front. It is all about spacing and very little about movement.
And another thing Wyoming's done pretty well is slow down the Husker run game. Taylor Martinez trying to change that, and he's wrestled down at the 40 by Patrick Mertens. Eric, only 52 rush yards now for Nebraska in this first half. That's not what they expected.
Well, not at all. I think that what they expected is to be able to move back this defensive line of Wyoming. And certainly right here, that's not what they're able to do.
Well, they've got an injured Wyoming Cowboy down on the field. Damon, you've got something to add to that thought?
Right now, Mertens is a man among boys. They are sliding him up and down the line, even though it's an odd front. He's played some three, he's played some one, and he'll play a true nose, too, where he lines up right over Pensick or Pelini, who has gotten some work in the first half. He has been awful tough to handle. And when you factor in Olive, who was gone a year ago, coming off an injury. Guys, these guys have been a gruesome twosome.
Well, and this is a defense that's been revamped this year. They went back to a 3-4 scheme. Last year, they were 117th in college football against the run. They allowed 232 yards a game on the ground as they help up Sonny Pulitasi on the field. And they're trying to figure out a way, Nebraska is right now, as to how to stop that offense. As Pulitasi looks like he's injured and he'll head to the sidelines. But this defense of Wyoming is kind of the untold story right now.
Well, I think Nebraska's got to make a decision in the play calling. Is Tim Beck going to want to establish the running game at this point, or does he want to go to the throwing game? So that's one thing that I think they got to get worked out. You know, it's still, you know, early in the game, so they just got to get some type of rhythm going. But right now you don't see it out of the Nebraska offense.
There's Tim Beck upstairs looking on. Trying to get the offense going here on second down and 7 at the 40-yard line. Nebraska down 4, 10.5 to go till halftime. Jamal Turner dropped immediately. Darren White,
stay with us,
a sure tackle at the 43-yard line, maybe a yard. Good tackle by White.
And right there on that play, Martinez just led him a little bit too much on the inside shoulder. So when he had to catch the ball, he had to turn around. And that's why he took that big hit at the end of the play.
Third down and 5 for Nebraska. Martinez, nobody open. Taylor can run. Eye on the marker, and he's not going to get there. Devin Harris able to close quickly and hold Taylor Martinez a yard short of the first down at the 46.
Really nice coverage in the secondary for Wyoming, and Taylor just really couldn't find anybody that was open. And again, you know, this is one of those times where you're happy actually to see Taylor Martinez tuck it and run, because maybe last year this would have been a situation where he would have thrown that ball late down the middle of the field and had a turnover.
Well, this secondary of Wyoming is thought of as the strength of this defense, at least the start of this year. They've played well so far. This has this Wyoming squad. Foltz on to punt away. Claiborne back deep, a flag down at the line of scrimmage on fourth down and 1. And the fair catch made at the 18-yard line. We'll see what this flag is about. Right at the line of scrimmage. It's going to go against Nebraska. Wyoming's going to decline it and take the football.
Illegal formation, offense. five men in the backfield. 5 yards added to the end of the kick. First down.
So they'll tack it on to the end of the kick. It'll be a first down, 9:16 remaining in this first half. Wyoming trying to add to their lead when we return to Lincoln. A little surprise brewing perhaps in Lincoln. 18th ranked Nebraska trails 14-10 to the Wyoming Cowboys. Damon Benning's on the field. I'm Kevin Kugler, standing next to Husker Heisman Trophy winner Eric Crouch. I believe, Eric, this is the portion of the broadcast, due to your contract demands, that we show Eric Crouch playing. This is a requirement anytime Eric Crouch is on a broadcast. And there's Eric Crouch leveling.
Thank you for doing this.
I noticed the giant number 7 on your jersey. It seems bigger than every number.
I don't know. I demanded that. I had to demand that, of course. You know, I had to, you know, it's got to be a couple inches on the bottom, a couple on the top, make it a little wider, you know. Got to be seen.
I appreciate that. And you were at that point. Now you're with me.
Of course, I fake pitched it too, you know.
That's true. Not helping you up hanging out with me up here, as the first carry by Sean Wick is stopped by Thad Randall at the 27-yard line. A 4-yard pickup on the play for Wick. Randall in there on the stop. And 9 minutes to go in this first half. Wyoming with a 14-10 lead and doing it on the ground. Over 200 yards of total offense in this first half, closing in on 150 yards on the ground.
I think you'd be a little concerned right now if Nebraska's defense allows them to drive down the field and score again.
Smith on the run. Rufran with the catch. And Rufran down at the 33-yard line in the arms of Bo Cisse. Close to another Wyoming first down. It'll be a few inches short, it looks like, based on where they're spotting.
Well, Dominic Rufran just got a little better position on Mo Cisse on that play. And with great accuracy, Brett Smith was able to hit him on the run.
We're going to give him the first down. So it is a first down for Wyoming. Damon mentioned it earlier. Dave Christensen believes, and they did research, if you get that first down, your chances of scoring go up 26%. But Ciante Evans trying to change that around for the Blackshirts as the senior nickel comes in and makes the stop.
Well, and this is such a huge play right now by Ciante Evans to be able to come off that edge and take the guy down with pure power and cause a loss of yards. I mean, that is probably the best defensive play we've seen out of this quarter.
Nebraska's had some trouble clogging up that middle. It got slowed up, and then Evans able to make the stop on second down and 10 at the 33. Smith, Rufran again, and a nice little gain to the 39-yard line. 6-yard pickup, and the fans trying to find something to cheer about, but it's been a up and down first half for the folks here in Memorial Stadium. The largest crowd ever at Memorial Stadium, 91,185.
Well, you wonder if Nebraska will tighten up those corners and the nickelback and the dime in some of these coverages, not let them just pick up 5-6 yards on first down.
Third and 4, high snap, flag down. Rufran trying to find some room, and a lot of red out there to bury him for a loss of 1 back at the 38. Green and Evans on the tackle, but the flag down along the line of scrimmage on third down and 4. And now we'll find out what that flag's all about.
Might have been a
there are fouls
offside
by both teams. Illegal formation. 5 men in the backfield. Offense. Offside. Number 4. Defense. Those penalties offset. Remains third down.
Well, they may offset, but that's a break for Wyoming. They did not get the first down. Now they get another crack at third and 4.
Well, I think in this offense, they like third and 4. If I'm Nebraska, I really don't know what their tendency is going to be. They've been so balanced today. They've been able to take the ball up the middle in the running game. They've been able to hit that quick pass on the outside. Nebraska's corners are a little bit soft right now. They give up the outside here.
Evans blitzing. Smith throws. The pass knocked away. Stanley Jean-Baptiste closing quickly on Trey Norman, able to swat it away, and it's fourth down.
And that's Stanley Jean-Baptiste just getting in there, planting his foot quick and making a great play, getting his hand in front of the football and breaking up that pass. We'll have another look at it here. You can see he just kind of, well, Smith threw off his back foot, wasn't really set. So Jean-Baptiste coming in there, making a great play with his body, getting his hand in front of the ball.
And what a huge play to get him in fourth down and get that ball back in your offense's hands.
Well, Damon, how about Stanley?
Yeah, he has played well. He's starting to jump routes. It's what we call concept route, guys, where you get the drag from the guy in the slot and you get the swing or the widening or the sit down route by the guy on the outside. And Nebraska's forced to make a decision. You can either play zone and bump the coverage, or you can play man and chase. Right now, it's advantage Wyoming.
Well, the advantage for Wyoming there was it got a big hop. The advantage for Nebraska was the momentum of that punt. 61 yards went into the end zone. Looked like an ugly punt, Eric, but then it took that field turf hop right over the head of Jamal Turner.
Sure did. He wanted the ball. He was starting to go after it, but then when he realized how much speed was on that ball, he kind of gambled and said, I think this one's going in the end zone. He was right.
At the 20-yard line, Nebraska's offense, 150 yards in this first half. Back to work. From the 20-yard line on first down, Amir Abdullah. Block up front from long. Abdullah with speed down the sideline. Can he beat White down the sideline? And White able to catch him. But Amir Abdullah with a gigantic run into Wyoming territory. Out of bounds inside the 20 and a first down.
And that's exactly what Nebraska needed out of this offense. A very big play. You can see Amir Abdullah, his speed to the outside. Broke contain for a 62-yard play. Exactly what we're talking about here, the explosiveness. This is what Amir Abdullah brings. You try to run him up the middle, he puts his head down and gets a big play. You try to run him on the outside, he uses his speed to get past those defenders.
Career-long run for Amir Abdullah. Here's Imani Cross giving Amir a breather, and Cross banging his way forward, pinballing down to the five. The ball pops out, and it's covered by Jamal Turner. Quincy Enunwa also down there. Huskers saying they've got it, and it's Enunwa who's able to pull it down for Nebraska. Cross almost coughed that one up, and now first and goal for the Huskers at the one.
I'll tell you what, that was pretty close, and having a big disaster here after a huge run by Amir Abdullah, and great heads-up play by Turner getting on that ball.
Martinez with Cross as the running back. Imani Cross, the carry, and he's in for the touchdown, and Nebraska back out in front.
His disposal of Amir Abdullah and Imani Cross. Imani Cross is the big 220-pound running back that they're going to give it to on the goal line. He just barrels his way through, shoulders down, weight forward, says, nobody's stopping me from getting in this end zone.
And the extra point is good. 17-14, Nebraska with the 3-point lead. 5:59 remaining in this first half as Imani Cross powers it over for six. Huskers back in front, 17-14. Kevin Kugler, Eric Crouch, Damon Benning, our entire BTN crew with you from Lincoln, Nebraska tonight. Imani Cross with the one-yard touchdown plunge to give the Huskers the lead, capping a three-play, 80-yard drive. Taylor Martinez bringing Nebraska back, and you see the most career wins as a starter. Taylor Martinez, one behind Aaron Murray of Georgia. I figure those two are going to be battling along with A.J. McCarron all year long for that active record. All three teams expected to have excellent seasons.
Well, he's certainly breaking a lot of records here in the Lincoln record books.
Erasing the name of Eric Crouch from many of them.
Yeah, I knew you were going to do that.
Good coverage by Nebraska. Down at the 18-yard line, Charles Jackson on the tackle. Imani Cross with the touchdown a moment ago, and that drive was led by this play.
I'll tell you, he had a great block set up. We didn't really mention that the first time, but Riz able to catch the corner. And, you know, like I said, his speed, like I said, he's pro ready. He's got great feet, and the things that he brings to the table as an all-around back really are going to help this offense in the long run. You can see that touchdown was really set up. I think Imani Cross is over there, you know, thanking Amir Abdullah for that long run, giving that 2-yard plunge.
At the 18-yard line, Brett Smith back to work for Wyoming. play action. Smith over the middle into traffic. Great grab by Robert Huron, and Huron all the way out to the 41-yard line before Harvey Jackson could bring him down. What a catch by Huron, 23 yards for the first.
Well, I think I know why his teammates call him Zoom. You see him zooming right across the field right there. And Brett Smith just throwing that ball in traffic. And you know what? It's a hard thing to do as a quarterback to get that ball into a tight space, but you got to have a lot of confidence in your arm, and Brett Smith has that confidence.
Brett Smith's got some confidence in his legs as well. Nathan Gary runs him out, but what a block downfield by Trey Norman to open up the path for Smith, who's had a great night. 13 of 17, 112 yards. He does have the interception that he threw on a 40-yard pass down to the goal line. But he's done almost everything right tonight for Wyoming. At the Husker 49. Not much running room there for Sean Wick, as Avery Moss, the freshman, able to make the tackle for a minimal gain, second and 10.
They're still trying to establish a running game here. You can see that. Using their quarterbacks, using their running backs. Their running backs are kind of all similar. They're going to let them get equal plays during this game.
Second down and 10 at the Husker 49-yard line. Miller, the motion man. Smith with time. Off the fingertips of Trey Norman. Coverage by Josh Mitchell. And it'll bring up third down. Tough one to catch there for Trey Norman, the junior wide receiver.
Yeah, I think what happened is Brett Smith, he set his feet. He threw a rocket in there. You know, he got the guy coming across. Just put it in there nice and easy. But you know, credit the coverage, too, because he was in his face and he had to cut his route off short. That's why that ball is thrown just a bit inside.
Third down and 10 at the Nebraska 49. And the snap over the head of Smith. He'll throw over the middle, and it's incomplete. Boy, Nebraska very fortunate that Jalen Claiborne was not able to pull that down, Eric, because there was a lot of green down the left sideline.
I know, if you talk about setting up a play, this was right here, other than the bobbled snap, because that play was wide open to Jalen Claiborne. There was nobody in the vicinity. That would have been a sure touchdown.
Huskers got the rush, Damon, but they dodged a little bit of a bullet there, too.
Yeah, they did. Gary was going to sit. He wasn't going to chase the guy that was on the out route running away from coverage. He was going to catch the crosser. He stopped when he saw the ball hit the ground. They dodged a bullet.
And the ball will bounce inside the one and into the end zone for the touchback. So Nebraska will not be pinned against their own goal line with 4:27 to go in this first half, and the Huskers trying to add to their three-point lead, 17-14. Bo Pelini's squad beat Wyoming 2 years ago in Laramie, 38-14. That game was close at halftime. If you'll recall back to 2011, Nebraska led just 14-7 at half in Laramie. That was Rex Burkhead's biggest game of his career. The series, Huskers lead all time 6-0. That 38-14 win the last time they met. Abdullah got his wind back after that 62-yard run. This one picks up three to the 23-yard line.
You can tell right now the pace of the offense has really kind of slowed down for Nebraska. They're not hustling up to the line of scrimmage and trying to run plays. I got a feeling they're really going to try to establish a running game and try to wear down the defensive line of Wyoming on this drive.
One thing we have seen, which was a huge emphasis throughout fall, ball security. Nebraska had 35 turnovers, including 22 fumbles a year ago. None so far tonight, as Taylor Martinez cradles that football just shy of the 30-yard line. Mark Genzacha on the tackle for Wyoming.
Well, here's another option play by Taylor Martinez. And, you know, you want to get down the line faster. He had a crease, but he's got to get there sooner. You got to come out of your break when you get the ball with full speed. That really sets up the play and the option, because you really get to your pitch man quicker, and you got the lane, you got the numbers, you got the outside. But without the speed at the quarterback position, you're not going to have the play set up.
And you've seen that a couple of times tonight as Taylor's run that speed option.
I mean, they're not used to running a lot of option football. We know that, but at least they got it in the package. You'd like to see him attack a little bit more aggressively.
And flags down and a little bit of motion on third and one.
False start. Offense, number 32. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
That's obviously not making Bo Pelini happy. On third and one, it becomes third down and 5.5 now with that penalty.
Well, obviously a different play call, and you can see it getting sent in right now.
frustrating for any head coach when you change the scenario from third and half a yard to third and 5.5. That's what Nebraska's had happen here. Martinez, the swing pass to Cross. No blockers in front, and this sure tackling Wyoming team able to close the door. Mark and Zacha, the junior from Germany, able to finish off Imani Cross. And Coach Christensen said, Eric, this is as athletic a linebacker as any in the nation, in his opinion.
Mark and Zacha did a great job of just getting out here and making a play. But, you know, Nebraska's offense are going to try to get on the perimeter. But this play, no blocking on the secondary, which is, you know, going to hurt your chances for making a big play.
Claiborne back deep, awaiting the punt from Sam Foltz. Foltz, a line drive punt. Back to the 21 is Claiborne. And Claiborne upended beautifully. Kenny Bell doing it all, making the tackle, getting blocked in the process. What a play by Kenny Bell.
When you got pure athletes out there at receiver, you put them in on special teams, they're going to make some plays.
56-yard punt. And watch one of the best wide receivers in the Big Ten make a great special teams play.
If you're ever in doubt, you might be able to use him on defense. You know, Kenny Bell comes in here with the speed. He breaks himself down and then takes the legs out.
Blair Burns pushing him in the back as he made that tackle. Didn't faze Kenny Bell. And now Wyoming, who had a scoring drive under 2 minutes earlier tonight, has 2:08 to work with to try to take a lead into the locker room. Brett Smith has been impressive tonight for the Cowboys. Miller with the carry. And Miller caught by Santos and Cooper, but not before he has a first down out near the 33-yard line, an 11-yard gain for Brandon Miller.
Yeah, I'm not seeing a lot of blitzing or anything out of the outside linebackers, the inside linebackers, kind of mixing things up. You know, their standard defense right now.
Smith over the middle, catch at the 45-yard line. Rufran down to the 48. He picks up 15. The clock will stop while they move the chains with a minute 44 to play first half.
You know, anytime you give Brett Smith the opportunity to set his feet and throw the football, I mean, you can see the accuracy that he puts on the ball. And you've got to get better position when you're covering a guy from Gary right there.
At the 48 of Wyoming, Smith. Nobody open, in trouble, throws back, and it's incomplete. Greg McMullen was pressuring, and Smith is down, a little slow to get up.
Offense.
And a flag going against Wyoming, adding
10-yard penalty.
The insult to the end of that play.
Well, I didn't feel like Smith really needed to get out of the pocket. I thought the protection was pretty good. You'll see up front, the linemen did a great job of just holding their blocks. Backing up, creating that pocket for the quarterback, and Smith just decided to take off to the right side. He really didn't need to do that. What he needed to do was step up in the pocket and stay with his reads and complete the throw.
Unfortunately for Wyoming, that line did too good a job of holding that pocket. And the penalty on Jake Jones moves him back 10. First and 20. Not much room for Wick. Trying to burrow forward to the 41. Valentine and Randall on the stop. 3-yard pickup. Clock running a minute 15 and counting. John Papuchis trying to get his defense to close out this half on a good note. Second down and 17. And Wyoming now not in a hurry.
Looks like they're going to try to go into halftime down 3 points. And
honestly, if you'd told Dave Christensen that when we chatted with him earlier, you go into the locker room down 3, he'd have probably said, let's take it, move to the second half.
I think you're right. And I don't think they're going to change much. I think they've had enough success in this first half. They're probably going to stick with the game plan that they've had so far. It's been working for Wyoming.
And a whistle as the officials come running in, a timeout taken by Bo Pelini in Nebraska. Before that second down and 17 snap, already in this first half, Dominic Rufran with a career high 7 catches. He has 60 yards receiving. Brett Smith, 14 of 20 for 127 yards. And Bo Pelini wanting to chat with his defense a little bit 38 seconds to go before halftime.
Well, I think he'd definitely want to chat with his defense, because what you've got is you've got an offense in Wyoming that's really spreading it around the field, giving it to the running backs and throwing it to the right side, quick passes, screen plays that they're trying to set up. So a lot of good things in the Wyoming offense.
Well, Kenny Bell, Nebraska's all Big Ten wide receiver, has been involved tonight. We saw him earlier on special teams. We see him on the edge. They just want to get him the ball in space, don't they, Eric?
Oh, absolutely. When you've got a player that's so dynamic like Kenny Bell, he's sure to make the catch, and he can make somebody miss. And he's a physical player. You can see there, getting a few yards after the first initial contact, and then making a play in the special teams to get this crowd and his offense really fired up.
17-14 advantage for Kenny Bell's Huskers. Waning stages of this first half. Smith on the keep, slides across the 49 to midfield. David Santos covers him up there, and it's third down and 8.
Well, it's that first step by Brett Smith. He just takes that foot and he plants it in the ground, and he's past the line. He's got 5 yards, and Nebraska's got to find a way to contain him on the edges, whether it's using the backers and the defense and maybe showing some twists or different stunts just to try to confuse the offensive line. But right now, we're not seeing that push on the linebackers and the defensive line from Nebraska.
And Wyoming not going to snap it again, and they are going to go into the line. Well, there's hold on. The clock ran to 0, but a timeout was taken, and they're going to have to put time back on the clock. Coach Pelini and Coach Papuchis looking at the clock, and they're going to put 2 seconds on the clock. So this half is not over yet. 2 seconds to go. Coach Christensen calls a timeout. And why not?
Maybe it's worth it. You know, yeah. I mean, you're down here. You're playing well right now. You're not down by much. I mean, the worst thing that could happen is you could probably throw an incomplete pass, maybe an interception. You do risk that. You could have a long return interception for a touchdown even. So, I mean, right now they must have pretty good confidence in that arm of Brett Smith, which so far he's shown to be the case. So why not take a shot?
The offense back out for one last look. 2 seconds remaining in the half. Wyoming down by 3. So 3rd and 8.
Looks like they're just going to take a knee.
All right. Took the timeout. Now they'll take a knee. And we will go to the locker room with a 3-point lead for the Nebraska Cornhuskers. A little bit of chippiness at the end of the first half. Some pushing, some shoving, some talking. And the Huskers will go into the locker room leading by 3, 17-14. Halftime is here in Lincoln. When we return, our Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report from our BTN studios in Chicago. The Cowboys battling, but they trail on the road to the Huskers by 3.
BTN is brought to you by Auto Owners Insurance. Protect what matters most with an Auto Owners Insurance independent agent. Find yours at autoownersinsurance.com. And by John Deere. The off-road just got roomier. The new Gator XUV A25i S4. Now with seating for 4.
Kevin Kugler back at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, where Nebraska leads 17-14. Time to turn to the quarterback that I've got in the booth, Eric Crouch, for tonight's Quicken Loans quarterback comparison. And it's two quarterbacks that are usually, Eric, the catalysts for their offenses. They certainly have been tonight.
Yeah, they sure have. If you look at the numbers here, you know, you look at Martinez's side here and 93 yards in total offense, and he usually produces more yards than that in the passing game. So it's not about what the yards look like now. It's about the wins and the losses at the end of the game. If he can keep his patience, he doesn't have to go out there and make a big play and force something, but just run the offense, manage this team, and get yourself a victory on the way out. And be confident in that. You got to be a leader. Voted the team captain. Watch him lead his team here in the second half.
Here's Brett Smith, another great leader. Coach told us he plays the position like a linebacker. We've seen it tonight.
Yeah, he has.
Brett Smith, Taylor Martinez, and their respective teams locked up at a good one here through one half in Lincoln. This crowd hoping for some more to cheer about in this second half. Obviously a 91,000 plus crowd that's mainly behind the Big Red.
Well, if you wanted to put a wager on which quarterback would have more rushing yards, I wouldn't have said Brett Smith at the beginning of this game.
Smith's been very good, as has that Wyoming offense. 300 total yards of offense in the first half, 238 for the Huskers, but Nebraska will get the football to start this second half. Kenny Bell, 3 yards deep. This time he'll bring it out. Bell, with great speed, has a hole across the 30 and down across the 35-yard line. Kenny Bell can explode DeAndre Jones, able to trip him up at the 35-yard line, a decent field position for Nebraska to start its opening possession of the second half.
It is. You don't know how big of a play that is. Just the small excitement that the crowd was given, and Kenny Bell took a straight line to get to the 35-yard line. A huge difference in starting from the 20 and the 30 in field position and play calling.
First down from the 35-yard line. Amir Abdullah motions next to Taylor Martinez. Taylor on the keep. Taylor across the 40, and a punishing run to the 41-yard line. He got hit hard by Blair Burns, but Taylor Martinez, who's taken a lot of punishment in his career, leveling a little here.
I'm not sure what the design was right here, but it looked like it just was a quarterback keep to the outside, and great pursuit by the Wyoming secondary and linebackers to hold Taylor to just a 6-yard gain.
Seathan Carter, Sam Birch out there as well. Here's Amir Abdullah, and Abdullah with a first down to the 49. He gets 8 on 2nd and 4. Move the chains for the Huskers on this first possession of the third quarter.
Yeah, and that's what Amir Abdullah brings to the table for Nebraska. You saw the quick little move, and then he gets upfield and gains the yards needed for the first down. There was no pity patter with his feet, no messing around. He made a quick move and got some yards.
Abdullah on first down, big hole. Abdullah caught at the 41-yard line after a 10-yard run. Marquestin Huff with the tackle. And Amir Abdullah hit that hole quickly and popped forward for 10.
He did, and Nebraska's offensive line just getting assignment sound and getting on a body and creating a hole now in this running game. This could be the difference to start the second half.
Martinez with time, nobody open. Taylor gonna try to run. And Taylor Martinez, a 9-yard gain to the 31-yard line, chased out by Tyran Finley.
He just thought for a second that Taylor was going to throw that ball when he didn't need to. But what a great decision. This is the maturity that we're talking about Taylor Martinez, and the difference between a year ago and in 2011. He's able to pull it down, make a smart play, and give his team another chance to get this drive, keep this drive alive.
34 rushing yards for Taylor Martinez. Here's Imani Cross with the good cutback. And now the spin. Look at Imani Cross go. He'll take it for 6. The juke, the spin, and 6 points more for Imani Cross of Nebraska.
I mean, what do? Do you highlight Kenny Bell? Do you highlight Amir Abdullah? Do you watch where Taylor Martinez is going? And then you've got Imani Cross, the big bruising back in the backfield, a little shake and bake, and great balance and speed to get in the end zone. A lot of weapons on this Nebraska offense.
I thought it was interesting as we talked to Tim Beck yesterday, and we asked about Imani Cross, who's thought of as the big back. He said, I have no problem running my entire offense with Imani Cross. We saw the run there, and the reason why. Imani Cross, the sophomore from Gainesville, Georgia, gets his 2nd touchdown run of the night. This time, taking it in to add to the lead. Nebraska up 24-14. Kevin Kugler alongside Eric Crouch with Damon Benning. 24-14, Nebraska with the lead as we play on in this third quarter. There's Taylor Martinez. Now, we were watching him over the last couple of plays of that possession, and it looked like before the handoff to Imani Cross, he was favoring his left shoulder a little bit. And with that in mind, Ron Kellogg III is starting to warm up on the Nebraska sideline. And Eric, he's warming up, looks like, with a purpose.
Well, I think they feel now this is a comfortable lead, you know, 10 so he can take him out of the game. But no, obviously something's happening. They're just going to maybe give him a little bit of a rest here. Maybe it's a little speculation of something on his shoulder, but
You know, we'll just have to see. He took that hit after that 6-yard run, and then sort of looked like he was favoring that shoulder, that left side a little bit, as Claiborne across the 20-yard line will set Wyoming up at the 22 with a first down and 10. Here's where Taylor Martinez took the contact after that play here. Keep an eye on the left side. Right there, the helmet from Huff came in, Eric, and popped him right on the shoulder. You see right there, he grabs on that left side.
Well, it looks like that helmet that we talk about now, the crown of the helmet just landed right into the mid part of his arm, and it jolted his shoulder back up in there. You wonder if there's, you know, if he looks like he's not in pain. He looks okay to me.
But he's not using that left arm. Not that he necessarily needs it to get a drink on the sidelines. We'll certainly find out in the next series.
Gotta keep an eye on that.
From the 22-yard line, Brett Smith. The handoff up the middle to Brandon Miller, and Miller stopped by David Santos just shy of the 25-yard line.
Well, they went to man coverage a little bit different than what they did in the first half, and were able to get a little bit more pressure on the running back and square up and get another guy in the box to help support the run game.
Second down and 8 at the 24-yard line for Wyoming. Smith under pressure. And he'll just throw this one away. Third down coming up. Let's check in with Damon Benning.
Hey, guys, it's real simple math. It was 6-on-6 with the quarterback being 7, the safety being 7 for Nebraska. What Nebraska is now doing is you see a safety. Number one, Harvey Jackson rolled down into the box. He is now the 8th run defender, which allows David Santos to fit immediately. Nebraska is going to have to disguise their coverage between 1 and 2 high safety to keep Wyoming out of that offensive rhythm that they were able to get in the first half.
Getting into it now on 3rd and 8. Trying to make it hard on Brett Smith and the Cowboys. And a whistle and a timeout's going to be called. Bo Pelini using his second timeout of the game, first of the second half. Both have been used on defense. Coach Pelini seeing something he did not like on that sideline, and he will talk it over with his black shirts. Well, next weekend, it is another slate of great regional action at noon. You'll see Penn State, Wisconsin, Iowa, and Purdue all take the field. Then at 6, Northwestern, Nebraska, and Indiana all battle under the lights. Next weekend on BTN and BTN to go. You'll be right here back in Lincoln next weekend, Eric, for Southern Miss.
Yeah, it gives me some
and Nebraska.
Rough memories on 99 when Southern Miss came to town. We're just on this goal line here, and squeaked one out.
20-13, I believe, was that score in 1999. Well, you know, I've stalked your or followed your career for a very long time.
Yeah, you let that one slip, didn't you?
And you know, I thought your choice of meal after that game was a little bit startling, at least what I could see from outside your dorm room.
Big old fat steak, is that what it was?
It was brought to you on a silver platter as the future Heisman Trophy winner.
Right, sure. I paid for it, by the way.
Of course, it's not a sandwich. Down for the Wyoming Cowboys. Smith, pressure coming again, and he's sacked. Randy Gregory with the sack of Smith, and a flag comes in late.
This is what they like out of Randy Gregory.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer, number 44 defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Bo Pelini wants an explanation. Roughing the passer against Randy Gregory on a sack. You don't see a roughing the passer call too often on a sack, like ever.
I've never seen it. I think this is a really interesting call, unless there was something that we didn't pick up, but How do you rough the passer? I guess I could see now what they're talking about is that he grabbed the neck area. So a horse collar type tackle probably is what they're looking at.
Bo is not going to be a big fan of that. And that's exactly what we're saying, and that's what we're seeing. Our referee Eddie Shelton telling Bo Pelini it's because he grabbed him around the neck. And that's why it's roughing the passer. So instead of getting off the field with the sack, the penalty, gives it to Wyoming and a first down at the 39-yard line. What a call to go against the Huskers.
Very good call defensively by Bo Pelini to put his young players in such a great position, and this is what he's talking about. He's seen this type of play out of practice. It's translating over to the game. Unfortunately, they couldn't pick it up on that play.
On the 39-yard line, first down. Open on the sideline, and another first down as Corey Cooper able to close out on the back. Brandon Miller coming out of the backfield. A first down at the 47, a 14-yard gain for Wyoming.
It is, and there was really nobody on him. And Corey Cooper was responsible for coming over and picking him up. And Brett Smith just saw him out of the corner of his eye and had a great quick delivery to get him the ball right on the money.
There's Wick with some running room, and Wick with another first down to the 36-yard line. Avery Moss catching up to him, 11 yards on the ground, and Wyoming put the pedal down again, Damon Benning. The pace picking up for this Cowboy squad. At the 36-yard line on first down, Smith. They just have to run. Good job of stringing that out by Jason Ankra, chasing all the way along the line. Nowhere for Smith to run, and it's second down.
See Bo Pelini get ready to make some calls, and he's been pretty calm. In the meetings, he was calm, he was relaxed. He feels very confident about this defense. It's just going to be a matter of settling in and playing the game and playing with physicality and playing with speed.
Second down and 10 at the 36. Pressure coming as Smith uncorks it for the end zone, and Rufran, and he overshot him. It'll be third down. Let's check in downstairs.
Guys, you got two D linemen head tapping right now. One of them is Randall asking to come out as he comes out. The other is Valentine. Nebraska a little less reluctant out of to shuttle in guys in and out. But I'm telling you, the key in this second half, look no more than how many guys Nebraska has in the two high look. Is it two safeties or one? It has now become, if it's two, we're running the ball. If it's one, look to throw it.
A little bit of a confused personnel right now for Nebraska. Guys coming on, getting pulled off the field. And on third down and 10, Smith with a screen set up for Claiborne. And Claiborne pounded down at the 33. Just a 3-yard gain. Big hit from Aaron Curry, the sophomore from Keller, Texas. Brings up a fourth down for Wyoming.
Oh, good job by the Nebraska linebackers not getting fooled. The play was going to go to the outside and really staying home, making a great play, a great tackle to put him in a fourth down situation.
Wyoming now 0 for 6 tonight on third down, despite having 19 first downs on the night. And here's Stu Williams. His long last year was 42 yards. This is 50. He hit a 55-yarder in a scrimmage earlier this fall. Williams with the kick, and it is no good. The junior out of Colorado cannot connect. John Papuchis is fired up. His defense holds Wyoming off the board. 10:30 remaining in the third quarter, and the score remains Nebraska 24, Wyoming 14. More to come on BTN. Our entire BTN crew welcomes you back to Lincoln, Nebraska, where Nebraska has a 24-14 lead. Defense holding Wyoming off the scoreboard. Defensive coordinator John Papuchis, yeah, he's a little bit excited. He's happy. Fired up with Ciante Evans.
Threw the Mike Tyson uppercut, too.
Not a bad shot there as the offense will head back out onto the field. And no worries, Husker fans. Taylor Martinez back out at quarterback after Ron Kellogg III was warming up. Martinez will hand off on first down to Amir Abdullah. And Amir out just shy of the 39-yard line. Eddie Yarbrough on the tackle after a 5-yard pickup for Amir Abdullah.
I'm amazed every time I see him grab the ball of how quickly he makes that first step. I mean, gaining 5 yards in a flash. And he hits the hole with precision.
Second and 5. Abdullah again tripped up near the 40-yard line. Lucas Walker got him first. After the game, the final drive brings you all the highlights from this game and around the entire Big Ten. The final drive tonight following the game on BTN. Huskers in this second half, Eric, seven plays, all but one a run, and an incompletion on that first series after going back-to-back-to-back runs. Third down and three. And the pass to the outside and a first down as they go to the air this time. And Kenny Bell in front of Tyran Finley makes the grab.
And I think that is exactly what you said there. All the runs and then all of a sudden the throw. And I think that's what, you know, you lull the defense to sleep thinking that you're going to be continuing to run the ball, trying to gain momentum, and then you come outside to Kenny Bell.
First down and 10 from the 47. Abdullah. Not much running room up the middle that time. Eddie Yarbrough, the reason why. He's got some pretty good ability on the inside. They were very eager to see what he could do after finishing the season with 42 tackles and four sacks a year ago.
Right, he's their energy guy on defense. Eddie Yarbrough just did a great job there of using his hands, coming off the block, and making a stop on Amir Abdullah.
Play action. Martinez gonna run. Worried about that shoulder as Martinez falls on what we thought might have been a little bruise at the 47-yard line. And there's Taylor again. Look at the way he's holding that left side, Eric.
Yeah, there's definitely something wrong. Taylor Martinez just rolling out and really just trying to make a play, an athletic play. But again, comes down that left shoulder. That's when he kind of got up holding it. He's holding it into his stomach area like he can't really extend it or lift it up.
He's not 100% right now. Third down and four. Martinez, low throw. Kenny Bell, did he get it? He did at the 38-yard line. Finley on the coverage. What a catch by Kenny Bell.
Well, Kenny Bell, I mean, just like he comes up to the line, and you got to respect him. You got to give him a little bit of space. And this is, they're doing that on the outside. They're giving him 8, 9, 10 yards, and they're going to have those in hooks all day long.
Huskers snap it quickly. A flag is down as the pass to Kenny Bell is complete to the 34, a 4-yard pickup. Flag thrown as Pulitasi and Finley combine to bring down Kenny Bell.
It looks like they're taking advantage right now of the off coverage. And, you know, you just try to cheat those corners up. They're going to see those passes. They're going to start to creep up a little bit, and then eventually, boom, you know, you take a big shot and you try to make the big play.
Mountain West crew tonight here in Lincoln.
There is no foul for 12 men on the defense.
So they had originally decided it was 12 men, and then they counted and found 11.
Yeah.
Counting is tough. They got it right.
Credit them for doing that.
And on second and six, back to work at the 34. Abdullah inside the 30 and down to the 28-yard line. Jordan Stanton with the tackle for Wyoming. Huskers right near the first down marker. And it will be a first down for Nebraska.
And now Nebraska finally here in the third quarter, really starting to gain control of this line of scrimmage, gain control of this game. They've got a 10-point lead. They're down in the territory, getting ready to score again.
Over 200 yards on the ground for Nebraska. And Abdullah over 114 carries, 107 yards. Pushing forward and a nice strong run down near the 20-yard line to the 21. Amir Abdullah tripped up by Marqueston Huff. Damon?
That's a lot of ominous foreshadowing after you reflect on the conversation with Coach Beck yesterday. He talked a lot about how tempo would be dictated by how the defense is playing. You get the sense in this second half that they wanted to slow it way down as the defense continues to evolve.
Slow it down and, Eric, wear them down. They have just been leaning on Wyoming in this third quarter, pounding out yardage on the ground.
Well, you can tell a little bit of urgency to get up to the line, but in some running formations, not in this spread them out, pass it type of situation, really trying to gain control and wear down the defensive interior of Wyoming.
At the 16-yard line, Abdullah in some trouble, and Amir Abdullah brought down by Jordan Stanton. We called his name a couple of times on this drive for the Wyoming defense. Came in from L.A. Pierce Community College in his first year with Coach Christensen's squad.
Well, as a middle linebacker, you do have that responsibility to try to find that ball carrier. You can say he's just got that knack for the ball. He's got Amir's number the last couple plays.
Martinez will keep. And Martinez runs right into Patrick Mertens. And Damon mentioned Mertens earlier as a guy who was moving all over the place. And Damon, another good example of what Mertens is able to do up front.
Yeah, he plays with such good leverage. He's a tall guy. He's 6'5". He's probably around the 295 mark. But you watch him use his hands and use his feet. He plays with tremendous pad level. And he's got versatility. He can quick you or he can power you.
He's a quiet kid who doesn't say a whole lot, but he is a quiet captain of this team. He's done a nice job tonight against what many people think is Bo Pelini's best offensive line in his now 6 years at the helm of the Huskers. Third down and 10, play clock at 3. Cross, nice cutback. Yamani Cross fighting forward, and he's got the first down to the 5-yard line. Tremendous run by Yamani Cross. And you think, Eric, here's a big guy, but he's got that great cutback ability, just able to plant the foot and go a different direction.
Well, he lost some weight, so he's got this foot speed, but a great block on the outside and a good job by Taylor Martinez of holding on to the last second to make that decision to give him the ball.
Spencer Long, the All-American, with the block. And now it's for Nebraska, first and goal from the 5. Terrell Newby, true freshman, with the carry. And Newby trying to turn the corner. He's knocked out of bounds at the 4-yard line. Darren White on the stop, and that's the first we've seen of a guy that Tim Beck called a little Amir when we were talking with him yesterday. Terrell Newby, the freshman out of West Hills, California.
Tell you what a compliment that is. And Terrell Newby coming out of the game, but just to be able to get that first play and get those nerves as a freshman coming in and playing for the very first time.
Second down and goal. Martinez looking for a noon run in the back corner of the end zone, and it's incomplete. He made the catch, but he could not stay in bounds. Coverage from Tyran Finley. Quincy Enunwa very close to a touchdown.
That's right, and Quincy just looking on the inside, and just a common fade route. Taylor putting it in a beautiful position to make that catch, and I'll tell you what, they may take another look at this play.
Quincy Enunwa saw it on the big screen, and he's saying, you need to challenge this, Coach Pelini. You need to challenge this. Quincy believed he had it, and he believed he got that foot in. Quincy Enunwa celebrating.
Yeah, he's doing chest bumps to Martinez already, thinking it's a touchdown.
That was the 15th play of the drive right there for Nebraska. Quincy Enunwa thinks he's got the touchdown. Take a look at these replays and see if we agree. Eric Crouch, what do you think? We'll slow it down. The catch, what about the foot? Got the ball right there.
Well, I dragged that right leg. I think he's in. Did you see the drag? The rubber came out of the field as he was dragging his right leg. The question, did he have the ball at the same time the foot was on the ground?
And the possession of the ball is going to be key. Let's see if we can see another angle here.
I think he's got this as a catch. I think this is the touchdown.
One more
tremendous job of dragging his foot the whole entire time.
Taylor watching it on the big screen afterwards. He says, hey, that's a touchdown.
Tell you what, he had some pretty good blocking inside there, too, to throw this quick pass by Trey Foster, number 42.
Not to harp on it. Did you see how Taylor put the arms up and then immediately pulled the left arm down again?
He's like, oh, wait a second, that hurt.
Yeah. Referee keeping a close eye on things, Eddie Shelton. Listening to our replay officials tonight. Two guys who are looking at this, Verl Sell and Brian Smith upstairs. They've made their decision, and now we'll get the official ruling.
After further review, the ruling on the field, touchdown.
Every scoring play is automatically looked at. That one was, and it ruled a touchdown, yes. So it is a touchdown, and Bo Pelini And the Huskers now have a 30-14 lead. Pat Smith with the extra point try. Nebraska by 17. Taylor Martinez finds Quincy Enunwa for the first time tonight to add to the lead. Some good highlights for Nebraska in the second half. A 31-14 lead after leading by just three at halftime. Alongside Eric Crouch, David Benning, I'm Kevin Kugler. BTN football tonight from Lincoln, Nebraska, before 91,000-plus, the largest crowd to ever see a game at Memorial Stadium after the expansion to the East Grandstand opened up more seating opportunities for Husker fans as the kickoff from the goal line. Claiborne going to work across the 15, but not able to advance any further. Good special teams by Nebraska. And that one will fall inside the 20-yard line. A little bit of pushing and shoving again as the East Grandstand all packed in tonight. New Husker fans, new season ticket holders finally got a chance after being on a waiting list to get into Memorial Stadium. You know they're loving it, Eric.
I know. Look at the seats over there. I mean, there's some really good seats. I took a walk through it on Thursday, and I'll tell you what, I would take any one of those seats over there. Very good views. Maybe that corner one.
They airlift most of the people in there to that upper deck because that's way up, but you do have a good view of the field from up there. It's a little ways away, but it's a good view.
Hey, I'll take a free ticket.
Yes, I'm sure Eric Crouch has to buy a lot of tickets to the Nebraska games. On first down, a flag is down as Brandon Miller works forward to the 19-yard line. Aaron Curry with the tackle. Flag thrown behind the play.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 98. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
And Vincent Valentine, a redshirt freshman, called for the face mask at the point of attack. Big Vincent, 6'3", 325-pound freshman. Logging up that middle. Getting some early playing time after that redshirt season. Kevin Maurice, a true freshman, playing tonight as well. Huskers have rotated freely through there. On first down, Smith over the middle, and a catch in traffic at the 44-yard line in front of Mo Cisse. Rufran with another grab. He has been a favorite target tonight of Brett Smith.
Yeah, and I tell you what, they're trying to really pick up the pace here with this offense, but what a laser-type throw. I mean, really good coverage by Cisse, but great job of getting the ball in there. Tight spot.
From the 44-yard line, Miller nowhere to go. Good defense by Nebraska. Jason Ankrum right there to make the tackle. No gain.
A couple big stops here, and Nebraska gets the ball back, and it's a different ball game. And I tell you what, they've really changed the tide. If they can get their Wyoming's offense is off the field, expect that running to continue on Nebraska's offense.
Second and 10. Nobody open. Smith over the middle finds Rufran again at the 45 and a first down. Andrew Green on the stop. And Brett Smith buying time once more to find the open receiver.
Yes, he did. And the ability to do all of that and set his feet and make an accurate throw is what's so impressive to me. And Dominic Rufran just, you know, getting a lot of looks here on this offense tonight.
Ninth catch of the night for Rufran. First down and 10. Smith again on the roll. Throws on the run, and the catch is made by Robert Huron. And Huron down to the 34, a first down. Josh Mitchell a little bit slow to get up. Still down for the Huskers.
Another fantastic throw by Brett Smith, rolling out to his left, which is a hard thing to do for a quarterback and throw accurately.
Evaluate that for me. As a quarterback throwing on the run, he's been very solid, almost better out of the pocket.
Yeah, he sure has. I mean, he sets his feet well. He turns his shoulder to his target. He throws a nice pass. He's got a great delivery. What I've seen is I compare it to Dan Marino, that quick delivery. Set his feet and throw it very quick. And actually, it comes with a lot of accuracy as well.
Mitchell gonna limp over to the sideline a little bit. Hopefully he'll be okay. The junior out of Corona, California, had 8 starts a year ago. In the regular season win over Wisconsin, he had a career-high 8 tackles last season. Huskers very deep in the secondary. Bo Pelini excited about what he's seen from those guys. Daniel Davey, the sophomore from Beatrice, Nebraska, into the ball game to replace Josh Mitchell. There's the defensive card alignment. The bingo board, the bear trap. I like the bear trap.
It's been a while since they've been down here on this part of the field for Wyoming. What do you expect the play to go towards the end zone?
At the 34. Smith slings it on the run to Rufran. Rufran with a block out in front, and he sideways himself for the first down near the 22-yard line. A 12-yard pickup. David Santos on the stop, but Rufran went sideways.
Kind of slithered through there to pick up that first down, and man, Smith's main target here on this drive, and it's working.
10th catch tonight for Dominic Rufran, a career high. On first down, Smith with time again. Smith now just going to throw it away. Let's check in again with Damon.
Guys, just to kind of add to that, okay, so Nebraska's answer to trying to fit in the run game was to drop a safety down in the box. Wyoming says, that's fine. I'll go to trips because you have to declare. You cannot disguise and drop late. Guys, some of the little nuances that are going on the field between offensive and defensive coordinators is good stuff. It's not as easy as it seems watching it on television.
Well, they're not. Well, they're out there playing the game right now, going to chess match kind of back and forth, but they're doing a great job of finding the holes in this Nebraska defense as they kind of move it around and become multiple.
Miller, good block out front. Miller punishing inside the 5, and Miller going to be down at the 1-yard line. How about Brandon Miller running over Randy Gregory to get down to the 1 where it's first and goal?
All right, I tell you what, Coach Blaine's going to be upset at that one. That was miscommunication. Nobody went with the number 3 wide receiver, hence a wide open Miller.
Heck of a block outside.
And now a whistle and a stop and play.
The previous play is under further review.
We're going to review this last play.
He's down at the 1-yard line.
Let's see if he got into the end zone. Well, they're going to check and see if he got into the end zone before he was down.
Yep.
See if we can see it.
He had a little lunge at the end. We'll see if it was enough.
That's going to be awfully close to a touchdown.
Okay.
Barreled over Andrew Green. And then Gregory fought through that tackle. Let's look at this one. This may show us the story.
I think the ball is crossed the goal line. That's going to come back and be a touchdown.
The way he fell in the arms of Gregory, and much like the Nebraska touchdown moments ago, Wyoming looking at the scoreboard and seeing what they think is a touchdown. Damon, from the field, you've watched these replays. What do you think?
Guys, I think that's a touchdown. He fell primarily on Gregory's body. It was a great block by Haran to kind of spring it. But again, just miscommunication. If there's anything to take away from the defensive performance thus far tonight, it's the ability to talk. We heard Coach Pelini lament on it yesterday. If he had text and could get everybody's cell phones, he'd have them text them the checks instead of just talking.
After further review, the ruling on the field, touchdown.
Yeah. He was in there. That's a good call, and I thought it looked that way live, guys.
And it is a touchdown for Brandon Miller, and Wyoming vaulting right back into this football game with an impressive answer drive. And the touchdown from Brett Smith to Brandon Miller brings Wyoming within 11, pending the extra point. Kick is good, and it's a 10-point game. With 2:04 remaining in this third quarter, Nebraska with a 31-21 advantage over Wyoming, an 8-play, 83-yard drive, answering Nebraska's 15-play, 67-yard drive, and Brett Smith 5-for-6 with the touchdown pass.
Well, a great block on the outside is really what allowed this to happen. And him to get in the end zone, this the extra effort of crossing the ball over the plane at the goal line to score that touchdown. And I'll tell you what, I'm kind of eating crow a little bit on that drive, because Nebraska had a little bit of momentum on third down, but not enough to stop him. And Wyoming got in the end zone and got right back in this ball game.
Not only are there 91,000 folks here at Memorial Stadium watching this game, but over at Pinnacle Bank Arena, a viewing party just a couple of blocks away in Nebraska's new basketball arena. And the Husker viewing party going on, and they're watching us over there and watching this game and very excited about what they saw earlier in the game. And they've been excited for a good portion of the night. In fact, the live shot outside. So what's going on just outside Pinnacle Bank Arena in a revamped downtown? Short kickoff. C.J. Zimmerer, the up back, down just shy of the 30-yard line. Let's take a look at that touchdown one more time, Eric. Now a flag first. We'll hear about the flag, and then we'll look at the touchdown. As Nebraska will be penalized here at the end of that kickoff return.
During the return, holding return team number 6, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Corey Cooper with the hold. Now the touchdown by Wyoming.
Again, and Wyoming really getting back in this thing, and Brett Smith delivering a rocket to the outside, and Miller just takes it. Yeah, he read his block perfectly, and you know, just not enough pursuit by the defense before he can get the ball across the goal line. And I'll tell you what, the Wyoming Cowboys are very much in this football game.
Here's Newby breaking one tackle, bringing some punishment against Marquestin Huff as he gets 9 just shy of the first down. He's the guy who made that block on the touchdown. Robert Huron, we've talked about him as a receiver, had to do a lot as a receiver, and he showed his blocking ability on that touchdown.
Well, if you're going to run the football, you've definitely got to be able to block on the perimeter.
They've run it tonight, 188 yards rushing for Wyoming. Speaking of running, Newby popping through a hole, just tripped up across the 35 by Marquestin Huff at a first down for Nebraska, Damon.
Yeah, Wyoming better be careful here. It's lightning in a bottle, as he was described as yesterday. And Wyoming's a little bit fatigued. You see them late getting play signaled in. And Nebraska has now upped the tempo a little bit. Watch Nebraska to try to gash Wyoming here right up the belly.
On the tempo is something that both offenses want to elevate, especially as this one goes on. But a good job by Sonny Pulatasi filling the hole and holding Newby without a yard on that first down carry.
Yeah, it sure was. He did such a great job of coming up there and filling the gap, and like I said, assignment sound and making a big hit and making a statement as well.
Tell you what, he just missed a huge backside cut there too. The young buck is still learning.
He's a true freshman. Now he's got a little bit of running room on the left side, and he takes it out just shy of the 43-yard line. Lucas Waka on the tackle, and Terrell Newby, the California running back that was ranked as the top running back in California, rushed for over 2,300 yards in his senior year, and Lucas Waka being helped up at the end of that play. There's Newby, the freshman, West Hills, California, honorable mention Parade All-American. His best game, his team won 78-34. He had 360 yards and 8 touchdowns in the win.
Well, Kevin, what this is telling me right now with putting in a young running back in Newby is that they're going to get him some reps. They're going to run the football on this drive like they did the last drive and try to eat some time off this clock.
On the second half, Nebraska's run 25 plays, 21 rushes. Newby to the outside, got a block, and Newby got the first down. And Nunwa was out across the 45-yard line blocking. Huff finally able to grab Newby across midfield, and a first down for the freshman Terrell Newby.
This has got to be pretty encouraging for Ron Brown, the running back coach, to see a young running back come into their system, pick it up, understand it, and come out here and make plays in the season opener.
And that play by Terrell Newby is going to be the final play of this third quarter in Lincoln. The fourth quarter coming. This game's still in doubt. A 10-point game through three quarters in Lincoln, Nebraska. The Huskers ranked 18th in the nation before the largest crowd in Memorial Stadium history. But the Cowboys giving Nebraska all they want right now. Through three quarters in Lincoln, Nebraska with a 10-point lead. Tomorrow, the top-ranked and defending national champion Hoosiers battle UCLA in a soccer showdown between national powers. Coverage starts at 2 Eastern tomorrow on BTN and BTN to go. Little Red is pumped up for tonight's season opener. Thank you. Appreciate that. More of that later. It's Eric Crouch laughing.
Kind of, I just want your picture.
I believe it's humoring me with that. Damon Benning on the sideline. I'm Kevin Kugler. Taylor Martinez sliding on first down and 10 to the 40-yard line. He gets 8 yards on first down. Mark and Zacha covering him up after the slide.
And at this point, no reason to take a hit unneeded. Your shoulder's already giving you some problems, I guess.
Newby out and Cross back in. We've seen great stuff from Imani Cross tonight. Amir Abdullah over 100 yards. And Terrell Newby, 5 carries, 34 yards. On the series, and Cross barreling forward for the first down to the 37-yard line of Wyoming.
Well, it's hard to say that this is encouragement because this is what they thought should have happened to a Wyoming defense that gave up so many yards in the rushing game. And it's just taken really to about the middle of the third quarter for that to take effect.
Like some Nebraska teams of yore wearing you down as the game goes along on the ground.
And Amir getting his C-note already and sitting on the bench and letting some of the younger guys take the rock.
Well, a good tackle by Patrick Mertens, the senior from Sterling, Colorado, who has played extremely well tonight. Damon's talked about him on and off throughout the night, and he has been extremely active. Holds Newby for no gain. It's second down and 10. Newby hurdling a man. And Terrell Newby down to the 31-yard line, a 6-yard run. And you've got to be impressed, a true freshman, trusting him, Damon Benning, with the game and just a 10-point game. It shows a lot of trust from Ron Brown, the running backs coach, and from Bo Pelini to put him into the game.
Absolutely, and he's a home run hitter, but perhaps his best asset might be his balance. It's awful good for a little guy.
Third down and 4 for Nebraska at the 31-yard line. Ball security was a stressor throughout practice, throughout the fall. Nebraska's not lost a fumble tonight. Newby able to stay on his feet, and he gets the first down. Tremendous run, and there's that balance that Damon was talking about, Eric, as Terrell Newby able to get the first.
Yeah, no, it's exactly what Damon's talking about, and here's why he's in the game, because they believe that he can really make big plays. And you don't know, this is a huge play to be able to make somebody miss and pick up the first down and keep your offense in a position to continue to drive down the field and score points. It's so huge, and it's got to be encouraging from the offense and Tim Beck to see a young player in the future of this offense.
And he's got those fresh legs here in the heat of the fourth quarter. 9 carries, 47 yards, 8 for 45 on this series. And now the play action. Martinez zips it over the middle. A great grab at the 10-yard line. Quincy and Unwin leaping up to pull it down in front of Blair Burns. It'll be first and goal at the 9. And
Quincy using that 6'2", 225-pound frame to jump up and catch the ball at the highest point. He used his body. He shielded off the defender. And Taylor threw a beautiful pass on point, on time, maybe a hair behind, but enough to protect him when he caught the ball.
And Unwin, 6'2", went up and cleaned it up. Here's Newby picking his way forward to the 7-yard line. He gets 2. Second and goal for Nebraska. 10-point lead with 12:10 to go in the fourth. Ron Brown, the running backs coach on the right. Damon, Ron Brown was the wide receiver coach in your day and in Eric's day, but now coaching the running backs at Nebraska.
Yeah, I'll tell you one thing that I admire is, you know, sometimes those backs from California get a little bit of a rap about being soft. I tell you, Newby is all man tonight.
Yeah, he's not shying away from contact.
He's slight in stature too, K-squared, so when you watch him, you can't appreciate how tough he is.
And they got the backers on their toes.
And a moonroll with the touchdown catch in the end zone to give Nebraska the 16-point lead.
Why not throw it to him again? Give him a second chance. He's on fire. He's live. He's a big target. He's obviously going to be able to come down with the football. He's more physical than the defenders that are covering him. Credit to Taylor Martinez for throwing a beautiful pass, putting it right on that back shoulder. Quincy just jumping up again, using his big body to shield off defenders.
And the extra point is no good. Pat Smith shanks it left. And so the score remains 37-21. Taylor Martinez looking for one of his co-captains, finds him in Quincy Enunwa. ...37-21 Nebraska by 16 here in the fourth quarter alongside Eric Crouch and Damon Benning. I'm Kevin Kugler. Have you ever wondered what it looks like to watch a game from way up high at Memorial Stadium in the new expansion? Well, there's what it looks like. Our director, Pat O'Connor, up there, pirate gear and all, leading the charge as Nebraska celebrates a touchdown up in the upper reaches of the grandstand.
I think Paulie's ready for a cracker.
Oh, it's nice to bring your yellow bird to the game on your shoulder. Does he need a ticket to sit in the East Grandstand? Bondi with the kickoff. Drives it through the end zone. He's been strong on kickoffs tonight. And out to the 25-yard line will come Wyoming and Brett Smith. With that missed extra point, though, Eric, holds the door open a little bit for Wyoming, down 16, still within two scores and two-point conversions of tying this ballgame.
Yeah, you're right, and I do think it's going to be tough. I think that Nebraska's established a little bit of a line of scrimmage here, and you see the graphic here at the defense, 98 yards allowed. But again, I can't sit here and say that it's not possible, because Brett Smith is an accurate passer. And they've had the running game going tonight. So, again, if they mix it up enough and get in the right positions, they could get another one in the end zone.
On first down, Miller driving to the 27-yard line. After the game, don't forget the final drive's got all the highlights from this game and around the entire Big Ten. The final drive tonight following the game on BTN. It is a very busy weekend for Dave and Coach DiNardo, Howard Griffith, three-day weekend, lots of stuff. It started Thursday night. Last night, Michigan State playing, full slate today. Good thing Coach DiNardo's buying. Down the sideline, an incomplete intended for Heron. Good job by harassing Brett Smith by Malik Collins, another one of those true freshmen on the field for the Huskers.
Exactly, and you just see him bowl through, and I think he just said enough is enough, and now I got to get to the quarterback and change his game and seal the deal. But Malik Collins pushing through there and getting in the face of Brett Smith, and that's the reason that he couldn't step into that throw and throw an accurate pass.
Third down and eight. Pressure again up the middle, and the pass incomplete, and here comes a flag. Flag thrown as Nathan Gary, the freshman, was on Dominic Rufran.
Pass interference. Defense, number 25. Spot foul. Automatic first down.
So a third and eight becomes a first and 10, Damon Benning.
Yeah, with cover zero, Nebraska rolling the dice and bringing the house. No deep hole safety or a guy in the middle of the field. We saw Nebraska when they were on offense. That's the play they scored on with the corner route to Jamal Turner, where Wyoming rolled the dice as well. High risk, high reward. You roll the dice, you want to come up seven.
They got themselves the first down with the penalty. 10 for Nebraska for 94 yards. There's a nice little scamper by Brett Smith to the 36. Greg McMullen, redshirt freshman, in there on the stop for the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Neither team has had a sack tonight. You'll remember the one sack from Randy Gregory was erased with a personal foul roughing the passer call that drew the ire of both Bo Pelini and defensive coordinator John Papuchis and most of the 91,000 here in Lincoln. Second and six, Smith under pressure. juggled and incomplete. Trying to hit Jared Darden. Ciante Evans out there on the coverage, and Ciante saying, not on that play, Jared.
Well, the backers, again, came up the middle to try to put pressure on Brett Smith, and they're trying to get in the face of Brett, and when it, and he does get in the face, you can see what happens. Incomplete passes, good coverage there by Ciante Evans. And
Darden's a big guy, 2'6", 220, transfer from Colorado. He's a grad student, leaving Colorado and playing this year. Looking deep for Roofran, and he's got it, and out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Josh Mitchell was out there on the coverage, but a beautifully thrown ball by quarterback Brett Smith.
He does, and he keeps this drive alive. Just saw that the deep coverage was there. He knew pre-snap that corner, that read, he was down. Corey Cooper came down on the coverage, and he just lobbed it over the top, and Roofran makes a great catch.
We've seen Brett Smith put the ball in some very solid places tonight. The keep by Wick, and Wick's got a first down to the 24-yard line. He gets 12. Harvey Jackson with the tackle, and Wyoming continuing to move the football. Another first down and knocking on the door.
Again, by mixing it up, too. And this has kind of been the story of the evening for the offense of Wyoming, is mixing up the play calling. Left, right, up the middle, throwing the touch pass when you have it.
Smith, the toss to Norman. He's going to throw, and Ciante Evans, no, it's not it. It's an incomplete pass, not an interception. Ball on the turf. Ciante says, let's look at the big screen.
Whoa, now that is a tough play there. You're asking the quarterback to throw a lateral behind the line of scrimmage and then have your receiver throw the football.
Here's the throw by Norman. Ciante Evans, that was awful close. Review this one. Remember, Brett Smith came in without an interception in 174 passes. He went 9 tonight before he threw a pick. Stanley Jean Baptiste with the early interception for Nebraska. Has he thrown a second, Eric Crouch? No, because it was thrown by Norman.
I'll tell you what, I think he scooped this one up.
Let's look at it again. Watch it here. We'll get a great look. We'll slow it down right there. Eric, I know you're always reluctant to give a defensive back any love.
Yeah, but sure, no. I think this is love credited. I think he picked this one up.
Ciante
got his hands underneath the ball.
Had a good time yesterday talking with Ciante. Very fun kid to spend some time with. Asked him if he feels like the grizzled veteran. He just started laughing. He said, I kind of do. Been here, it seems like, a long time. He had one pick last year. He returned it for a touchdown against Idaho State. He may have a pick here of Trey Norman.
After further review, interception, Nebraska. First down, 10-yard line.
The reviews have gone Nebraska's way a couple of times tonight. One for a touchdown, this for an interception, and it stymies a Wyoming march.
Sometimes when you're the captain of the defense, Ciante Evans coming up with a big play here in the fourth quarter. Haven't heard his name a whole lot tonight, but comes up with a nice little sneaky play to pick that ball right out of the air as an interception is going to put Nebraska's offense back on the field.
And Damon Benning, if you're a Wyoming fan right now and you just watched your team go down the field again, are you upset that there was a little bit of trickery there and somebody other than Brett Smith was throwing the football?
Well, I think if you, as a fan, I think those guys are well aware that they have a lot of little things that they do that are unconventional. I think you take that as part of being Wyoming football and you roll the dice. It was a good play call by design. Just you don't play on guys like Ciante Evans not falling asleep. There's a reason he's the veteran back there.
Out to the 15-yard line before Patrick Mertens can make the stop. Now Nebraska going to try to crank up that ground game once again as Ciante Evans getting a little bit of the cool zone, as cool as you can find on a still steamy night in Lincoln. On second and five, Newby fighting out of the hold of Kulatasi, and Newby with a flag thrown at the end of the play as he was hit out of bounds, and that's going to tack on yardage at the end of the run by Newby.
Well, now it's getting a little bit ugly here. Wyoming with the interception and then the big possible late hit out of bounds, what we're looking at.
Dead ball, personal foul, defense, number two, late hit out of bounds. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, there was a lot of talk about this young man in the fall, and Terrell Newby doing nothing to disappoint tonight.
Well, I like the sidestep there. It was a quick move and then used his hand just to kind of bat away the aggressor coming up to make the play and picking up a little 15 extra at the end.
And a big hole for Imani Cross. Cross banging off would-be tacklers down to the 41-yard line. Imani Cross with another big run of 18 yards and a first down. We've seen good stuff out of all three Husker backs.
They got to be pretty happy right now with the running back position and what they have. And, you know, Damon can speak to this right there. Imani Cross cutting weight, bobbing and weaving, and then putting his head down at the end of the run and finishing it off.
Yeah, like, again, Beck let us know that, hey, he's comfortable running this full set of offense with Cross. But here's the deal. Wyoming's offensive line or defensive line are the last guys to get up off the field. That is never a good sign, guys, when teams are running hurry up on you.
Well, they are worn out at this point.
There they
go. Down the sideline again. And Damon, Nebraska is just going to continue to lean on this Wyoming defense right now, aren't they?
I tell you what, and when you hear the pad pops, there's a dictator and there's one that's being dictated too. And you can guess that the guys in red are being the dictators. They are reestablishing the line of scrimmage. And the crazy thing is it's not far-fetched to see that it's about 4 or 5 yards from where they're originally snapping the ball. You see a wave of white moving backwards.
Now, Eric, you and Damon both were part of teams that did this on a regular basis in Lincoln.
Well, I tell you what, the energy that you get from looking across the ball and seeing defensive linemen and linebackers puffing and puffing and have their hands on their hips just kind of saying, hey, I can't take anymore.
Well, you've got a team from Wyoming that it's been warm in Laramie. Altitude is about 7,000 feet. They're not getting this humidity that we've got tonight. It is a very, very tired team right now. Cross with 91 yards. Newby with 72. Martinez, 78. Abdullah, 117. It's a lot of Husker backs that are putting up some good numbers right now. Huskers with 358 yards on the ground going into this first down and 10 carry. Newby running up the middle into Patrick Mertens, who's played some excellent football tonight. Eddie Yarbrough in there as well for the Wyoming Cowboys. And Nebraska just going to kind of run the clock. You see the numbers, 360 yards rushing under Bo Pelini. They are 12-0 with 300-plus rushing yards. They led the Big Ten last year, averaging 253, well above that tonight.
They sure are. It's kind of like the offense of the old days here. I mean, you got to credit the Tim Beck scheme and offensive mind that it's not just a passing team here at Nebraska. They have really done a great job rushing the football.
Westerkamp, Birch, and Moore, the wide receivers on the field right now, second down and 8. Newby right up the middle. And just shy of the 25-yard line, Terrell Newby is stacked up, and it'll bring up a third down. And Nebraska is taking the air out of the ball right now as Ron Brown's running backs carrying the load for the Huskers. It's been a good night for all three running backs, and the debut of Terrell Newby has gone extremely well for the Huskers.
Trying to chew some time off the clock here and in a 2x2 formation.
Third down and 6 at the 25. Westerkamp, Moore, Birch back out there on the field. Trey Foster out there as well. And the toss is intercepted. Picked off by Blair Burns. Down the sideline. Burns across the 40, across the 45. And Wyoming is not done yet as Taylor Martinez turns it over. And Wyoming's got it near midfield, down by 16. So the Huskers on the ground, able to move it, but they go to the air. And Taylor Martinez throws the pick. Wyoming's ball when we return.
Football in BTN is presented by Buick. It's your kind of luxury. And brought to you by State Farm. For auto, home, life, and banking, get to a better state.
Fourth quarter, 6:26 remaining in this final stanza. 37-21 Nebraska by 16. Taylor Martinez throws the interception, turning it over to Wyoming. The Cowboys start from the 48-yard line. First down and 10, best starting field position of the night for Wyoming and quarterback Brett Smith. Pressure coming up the middle. Smith able to get away. And Brett Smith again finds an open receiver for a first down after dodging the initial rush. He's done it all night long. Tracks down Claiborne and a first down for Wyoming.
I tell you, time after time, is he able to just set his feet and throw the ball and make just a quick adjustment in the pocket. And that's what's keeping these things going for him on offense.
Smith over the middle for Claiborne. He's got it for a touchdown. Didn't take long for Wyoming to turn the interception into 6 points. And with 6:02 to go, the Cowboys back on the board within 10.
Smith here just taking that three-step drop. Pre-read, knowing that the safety was sustained in the middle of the field, so he kept him up that hash. Great throw, great catch, and they're back in this game.
We talked about it earlier, the missed extra point by Nebraska, leaving the door open ever so slightly for still a two-score game. Now, they'll go for two here, trying to get within 8 points with 6:02 to go in the fourth. Smith in trouble, and Smith is sacked by Josh Mitchell. Mitchell getting to the quarterback and thwarting the two-point conversion and keeping it a 10-point game, 37-27. Josh Mitchell, the junior, making a big play. Still a 10-point game. Nebraska 37, Wyoming 27, with 6:02 remaining in this fourth quarter in Lincoln, alongside Eric Crouch with Damon Benning on the field. I'm Kevin Kugler. It's time for the John Deere Gator Game Changer. It's Amir Abdullah, 17 carries, 117 yards, that 62-yard scamper set up a Husker touchdown from Amani Cross. And Eric, Amir Abdullah doing what we've become accustomed to seeing him do in his house.
I'll tell you what, I've been really excited to watch him play. And just watching a few practices that I've seen early on this camp, he is just quick. He gets it. He understands it. He hits the hole with speed. He's very competitive. He wants to win. And when you see a back of his size, you kind of say, well, he's just a slashing guy. He's not very powerful. But he's not afraid to put his head down and gain that extra yards in the running game.
Smart play made by Tariq Allen. He called for the fair catch as he chased that little short pop-up kick, and a flag is down right near the line of scrimmage.
Offside, kicking team, number 13. 5-yard penalty, first down.
So the Huskers get an extra five after the offsides on the kicking team. And with 5:55 to go in the fourth quarter, the Huskers with the football and a 10-point lead. Nebraska may get out of here with the win, still in doubt, but it's going to be a lot of things to work on for Bo Pelini's squad, especially on the defensive side of the football. Wyoming's 4 yards shy of a 500-yard night tonight. On the 40-yard line, first down, and out to the 42 goes Amir Abdullah. Blair Burns on the tackle.
We talk about Bo Pelini and his defense and what they bring to the table, and it's really about coaching the concepts. It's not about going out and just making individual plays. He talks about teach what's not on the film. You say, well, what does that mean? That doesn't make sense. But you teach what's not on the film by teaching the concept, showing it different angles, different plays, what players can come out and do, and that's how the guys understand it eventually as the season wears on.
Abdullah trying to get to the outside, breaks one tackle, but he cannot get away from Eddie Yarbrough. Give Pulatasi some credit. He got there first, slowed up the play, forced Abdullah to change direction, and Yarbrough cleaned it up.
He did, and a little bit surprising that, you know, Abdullah comes back in the game after sitting out and, you know, Terrell Newby doing a great job, and Imani Cross having, you know, his night of putting his shoulders upfield and making plays. And it just looks like you're getting a little bit complacent here at the end of this game, which is not over.
Third down and 13. Martinez. Open receiver is Kenny Bell, and Bell's got the first down. Marqueston Huff on the tackle at the Wyoming 48, but a 15-yard gain and a good throw by Martinez to Kenny Bell.
Well, sure was, and this was an opportunity for Taylor to have the full field read. He went to the right side and then came all the way back late, found Kenny Bell at the sideline with an accurate pass to keep the sticks moving.
Now Imani Cross in the backfield. Nebraska content to use a little time here. Play clock still at 15. As we slip under 4.5 to play in this fourth quarter. Cross, nice run just right up the gut to the 42-yard line. He picks up 6. Imani Cross, 9 carries for 97 yards tonight. Devin Harris with the tackle. That's a good production. You've got Cross at 97, Abdullah at 114, Martinez has rushed for 78, and Terrell Newby, 76 yards. Everybody averaging over 5 yards per carry.
Right, and hats off to the offensive line. You know, being able to establish the ground game and the leverage, the lower man wins, pushing that defensive line back, and talking to John Garrison throughout this offseason, his line has a lot of confidence as a lot of seniors are up front leading this offense.
Cross caught by Mark and Zacha, and now some pushing afterwards as Cross trying to run upfield. Marqueston Huff blocking his road, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2.
Well, Tim Beck has got to be pretty excited about what the offense has done tonight, especially in the running game. And you know, the passing game, it's great to see Taylor Martinez have some downfield throws. You know, everybody gives him credit for those short passes that he can complete 90% of them. But when it comes downfield, it's about Taylor Martinez making that deep throw, making that read across the field, watching the safeties in the corners and throwing on time. And he's done that a few times tonight.
3rd and 2, Imani Cross. Very close to the first down. Looks like they're going to spot just a shade short. Lucas Walker with the tackle for Wyoming. 2:35 to go in the fourth. And now 4th down and 1 yard to go. And there's an injured Wyoming Cowboy. Looks like Tyran Finley will be cramping up and is going to go down at about the 26-yard line. It is hot, it is humid. A very warm night. Finley, though, a guy who took the starting job from DeAndre Jones in camp. They call him Smiley. He's always positive, always has a smile on his face. I say always, that's before that injury. He's probably not smiling right now. Next weekend, it's another slate of great regional action. At noon, you'll see Penn State, Wisconsin, Iowa, and Purdue all take the field. Then at 6, Northwestern, Nebraska, and Indiana all battle under the lights. Next weekend on BTN and BTN to go. As they help Tyran Finley off, let's check in again with Damon.
Yeah, that was an example of a guy playing through the whistle. Quincy Anunwa has been wearing Finley out in the run game. And I think Finley let up a little bit, thinking that the run was away from him. And Anunwa continued, as Quincy often does, finished the play, drove him to the ground, and you saw Finley's leg give out just a smidge.
Well, Quincy has done a lot of nice things tonight. And Eric, we were talking during the break, and it's surprising that Quincy Anunwa doesn't get targeted even more than he does. He's a talented wide receiver.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more, Kevin. I looked at some of these guys along the sidelines, and I said, that's not a bad day at the office when number 18 is your third wideout. He's as good as anybody out here, and he makes arguably the most difficult of the catches of anybody. He's got great hands.
On 4th down and inches, Taylor Martinez trying to sneak it forward, and I'm not sure he got it. He did not. Wyoming with the stop. Marqueston Huff able to come in and lead the charge, and a little bit of a boost of momentum for the Wyoming Cowboys.
Yeah, it sure is. They really needed to stop that play to get the ball back and have any chance of throwing a ball towards the end zone or getting the ball in the end zone, but I'm so sure there was a second effort here by Martinez.
Steve, do you want Taylor?
Tell you what, rip that ball out of the hands of Taylor Martinez on fourth down.
I don't think it was a matter that he didn't get it. I think that he ripped the ball out of his hands.
Either way, it's a turnover to Wyoming. And a quick toss to the outside and some running room now for Gentry and a first down into Nebraska territory at the 47-yard line. Randy Gregory on the stop. Some folks who snuck out of Memorial Stadium may want to try to climb their way back in if Wyoming has its way.
And Gentry, being a young buck, could have taken it to the outside and stepped out of bounds and stopped this clock.
Smith with all kinds of time. Fires to his favorite target tonight, Rufran, but a little too tall. It's a long throw from that far hash to the far sideline. Second down and 10. From the 47-yard line of Nebraska, 10-point lead for the Huskers with a minute 42 to go. Brett Smith. Open, catch is made, headed for the end zone, Huron, touchdown! And Wyoming is within four with a minute 32 to play.
I think Bo Pelini's over there kind of shaking his head like, what is going on here late in this football game? And what's going on is it's Brett Smith. Dropping back again and putting the ball on the money. And credit Huron for going up and grabbing that thing. And there's no pursuit by Nebraska on the back end.
26 of 38, 351 yards, and four touchdowns tonight for Brett Smith. The extra point is good, and Wyoming, with all three timeouts left, within three and a minute 32 to play. And Huron gets Wyoming a lot of life with this long touchdown grab of 47 yards.
And what Brett Smith saw there is just an opening on the outside. He had his man beat. Right there, Corey Cooper beat on the route. Bad positioning by Cooper, and Huron taking complete advantage of that. And Brett Smith knows that there is still time on the clock. And 3 points, he's feeling pretty confident.
1:32 to go. And an onside kick coming here for the Wyoming Cowboys. Nebraska's got the hands team again in, as they did on the previous Wyoming kick. Coach Pelini and his defensive staff gonna have a lot to talk about after this one. Wyoming, 558 yards and 33 first downs. They've chewed up 207 yards on the ground and 351 through the air.
Well, to have a lot of game footage to go over, a lot of learning experiences by some of the young freshmen and sophomores that are out there on defense, and you take it in, absorb it, and you bring it back to the practice field to try to get ready for next week's game.
Justin Martin with the hands team ready for Nebraska. Birch out there, Jamal Turner. Onside kick coming from Martin. Wyoming Cowboys within three. Shift sides. It goes 10. It's batted to the sideline and out of bounds. Jamal Turner with the swat to spike it away. This one's not quite over, though. Mentioned a moment ago, Wyoming has all three timeouts. They're going to use them on defense.
That's right, but what a heads-up play by Jamal Turner and swatting that ball and getting it out of there. I tell you what, this is such a huge play. The pressure that they could have put again on the Nebraska defense. And now we may not even see the defense take the field again.
Coach Christensen knew it was close. Good play by Jamal Turner, former quarterback in high school. From the 43, first down and 10 for Nebraska, leading by three. And Imani Cross caught by Yarbrough. No gain. Timeout taken. The initial signal was timeout taken by Nebraska. I'm pretty sure Nebraska did not take that timeout. That would be Wyoming's first charge timeout. They'll have two remaining. Don't forget, immediately following our game, the final drive's got all the highlights from here and all around the Big Ten. The final drive following our game right here on BTN. Anxious to hear what the crew in Chicago thinks not only of the rest of the Big Ten, but this game. Watching Nebraska's defense retooled with a lot of young faces have some real ups and downs tonight against a Wyoming offense that has looked extremely strong on the road.
Well, I think that was to be really expected, knowing the numbers of freshmen that they had to play and different packages that they were putting in. Bo said he wasn't going to let up on the gas. He was going to call his defense and see how these guys reacted to it. And you take that back and implement it into practice and next week and start to develop chemistry between the defensive unit.
Imani Cross gets out of bounds. That is not at all where Nebraska wanted to go, because it's just saved Wyoming a timeout and now third down.
Anything, just slide on your knees right in bounds. Keep that clock moving and force the timeout.
So a minute 20 to go and a gigantic third down and five for Nebraska. And Amir Abdullah is going to come in now and replace Imani Cross. Third down and five. Huskers by three with a minute 20 to play. Taylor Martinez will keep. He's not going to get it. Eddie Yarbrough reading it perfectly. Coach Christensen fired up. A minute 15 to go. Wyoming takes its second timeout. And Wyoming's going to have one more chance to try and win this football game.
Bo Pelini's got to be wondering what defense he's going to call here. We need to get pressure on the quarterback. But take a look at Martinez and Yarbrough just wrapping him up and getting in the backfield, and the excitement out of Christensen, knowing that he's got a chance now.
And Damon, the way this Wyoming offense has performed in this late third and most of the fourth quarter, Bo Pelini's got to be very concerned right now.
Yeah, he is. You know, there's a lot to be said for X's and O's sometimes, but more importantly, there's a lot to be said for execution, whether it's head on the right side of the ball, defending a pass with your longest arm, or guys, most recently, not going out of bounds. Sometimes we can be our own worst enemies.
Tonight, Brett Smith, who's going to get another opportunity here after this punt, has accounted for 431 yards of total offense. That's the seventh best all time for an opponent against the Huskers. It's the best since October 6 of 2007, as Kenny Bell catches the punt at the 7-yard line. Who had it on October 6th of 2007? Chase Daniel of Missouri. Who was calling the plays? Dave Christensen, who's now the head coach at Wyoming. And it comes down to a 67-second possession from the 6-yard line. The fans rising up here at Memorial Stadium. 3-point ball game.
Got to be concerned right now if you're Nebraska's defense and how they've allowed Brett Smith to really tear this defense apart in the running game and in the passing game.
Wyoming with one timeout from the 6-yard line. It's the worst starting field position of the game for the Cowboys. From his end zone, Smith gonna have to scramble. Smith to the sideline, has the first down and gets out of bounds at the 18-yard line, a 12-yard scamper, 58 seconds to play.
What a nice heads-up play there. Looked like he might just have got 8 yards, but then that little quick step, that scoot to try to get the first down and get out of bounds. Smart move in stopping the clock.
From the 18, pressure coming. Smith throws it away. Had Gregory, or rather Avery Moss, in his face as he got rid of that football. Gregory back there as well. And it's second down and 10.
And that's exactly what Nebraska's defense needed. Some push on the defensive line, get in his face, make him throw a bad football. And they did just that.
Second down and 10. Five receivers into the pattern for Wyoming. Four-man Nebraska rush. Smith pumps. Smith flagged down. Ball out of bounds. Intended for Rufran. The flag back at the 10-yard line, thrown in a general direction of a hold or a penalty against that offensive line.
Holding. Offense, number 51. 10-yard penalty. We play second down.
Huskers will move them back. And they'll mark it all the way back to the 9-yard line. Ciante Evans limping a little bit. That's a guy you don't want to see leave the field if you're Nebraska in this situation. Second and 19 after the penalty. 41 seconds to play. Hit by Josh Mitchell after the catch on that far sideline by Brandon Miller. Gain out to the 14, a pickup of 5.
They're trying to creep those corners up in that bracket type coverage and then maybe take a shot downfield.
Third down and 14. Crowd trying to get into it again. Smith has a man across the 25, short of the first down. Claiborne. And a timeout's going to be used by Coach Christensen in Wyoming. Their final timeout, Nathan Gary on the stop. It's fourth down and 1 at the 27-yard line, and the game comes down to this play right here. 37-34, Nebraska trying to survive in the season opener. They've not lost a season opener since way back in 1985. 27 straight openers Nebraska has won. They're 37-5 at night at Memorial Stadium since the first night game in 1986. This has usually been a slam dunk, combine a night game with a season opener, and that's been a win. But Wyoming's giving them all they want tonight.
You think about the defensive call here for Bo Pelini. And do you gamble and try to put pressure, or do you sit back and not give up the big play?
Fourth down and 1. 27-yard line. Wyoming must get a first down or it's over. Smith gonna keep it. Flag is thrown as Smith slides for the first at the 30-yard line, but the flag thrown right into the middle of the line, and that's going to be a hold against Wyoming.
Holding. Offense, number 50. 5-yard penalty.
Boy, a huge break there for Nebraska. 22 seconds remain in this fourth quarter, and instead of fourth and 1, we're going to have to work now with a 4th and 11.
We take a look at Perez. He just kind of tackled into the ground. He has arms wrapped around him.
Clock running. Brett Smith's got to get the snap. 4th and 11. Smith throwing. Can he pull it in? He does on the sidelines. A tremendous grab by Jalen Claiborne and a first down the 31. What a catch.
Great catch, great throw. Another way Brett Smith keeps this thing going. It's just amazing what he's been able to do, getting good protection from his offensive line on that last play.
And 11 seconds to work with. Smith now with 8 seconds. Clock still running. Nobody open. Smith looking deep. Nobody open. The clock at 2 seconds, at 1 second. Time has expired. This will be the final play of the game. An incomplete pass. And the ball game is over. And Nebraska hangs on to a 37-34 season opening win.
Tremendous job at the defense. Not allowing a guy to run free and wide open. And getting out of here with a victory and getting on to next week. Bo Pelini's got to be very excited about this.
Ciante Evans is worn out. This Nebraska defense allowed 602 yards tonight to the Wyoming Cowboys, an offense that last year was 70th in college football. But the Huskers hang on for the win, and Damon Benning's got Bo Pelini.
Coach, you said you learned a lot about your team after the lights came on. You're in the moment. I know it's fresh, but what do you think you can come away with thus far?
Well, I mean, obviously a lot of work to do in a lot of different areas. I mean, there were some good things we did out there. There's a lot of things we need to get fixed, and they gave us a lot of things defensively. At times we reacted good to it. At times we didn't.
Coach, if you want to take the optimistic role, you're not going to see much more in terms of what you can be thrown at on offense with a young defense. You're going to test their mettle.
Oh, I mean, I said that going in. I knew that was going to be the case. We got a lot thrown at us, and there was a lot of adjusting that needed to be made. And when we made the adjustments, you got to make the plays. And, I think we'll learn a lot from this, and I think we'll make a big jump going into next week.
Coach, the biggest adjustment that you just made or just alluded to was between week one and week two. How do you go back to work thus quick?
Well, I think our guys will learn a lot from this. I think they'll learn a lot. We have a lot of guys that experience this for the first time, and I think we'll be better because of what happened tonight. I'm just glad we got out of here with the win. You got to give them some credit, and we'll get better.
Coach, appreciate it.
Thanks, thank you.
Guys.
All right, Damon, thank you very much. Bo Pelini and the Huskers with the victory tonight, 37-34 over the Wyoming Cowboys.